Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, children of most ages, how you folks doing? Welcome here to the show. My name is Conman167, and it is fantastic to have each and every single one of you. Are you ready for a good time? That's what the theme song asks you each and every single week. It's time for Friday Night Smackdown. Let's go! And Sonya Deville kicking us off in the center of the ring. If you guys are pumped, if you're ready for that good time, then give me that hell yeah.
We have an incredible show here tonight in New Orleans. But first, I have to acknowledge the unprovoked, unprofessional, egregious attack on me last week by Ronda Rousey.
Oh, okay. All right. We're getting right into this. Getting right into the attack from last week.
Ooh. People like Ronda Rousey and Naomi think that they can do whatever they want and there'll be no consequences because they have no respect or regard for authority. But I'm here tonight to say, I don't care if you're Ronda Rousey. I don't care if you're Naomi.
Shit.
Or any other superstar on the roster.
You don't care? You're in a sling, girl.
There will be consequences for your actions.
Ooh. You gonna do it with one hand?
There has to be.
There has to be, she says. What do you guys
with
think the consequences
said,
are gonna be?
Earlier today, I petitioned upper management that Ronda Rousey be fined $100,000.
What? $100K for that? Really? $100K? Chump changed her.
Immediately.
What? What?
Definitely.
No, come on. Oh, come on. This is just to get her off TV, isn't it?
Sonya,
well, there it is.
Sonya, hold on just a second.
Oh, whoa. Never mind. Here comes Scrap Daddy.
Your email as you're in the ring, but upper management has responded to your petition.
Is she actually suspended?
This email comes from the chairman of the board himself.
Whoa, Vinnie Mac.
McMahon. And it reads, Sonya, it has come to my attention that you've been taking matters into your own hands.
Wait.
And abusing your power.
Oh, no.
If there is one thing I can't stand, it is a WWE official who abuses their power. So now, I will exercise some of mine. Your petition to fine and suspend Ronda Rousey is declined.
Oh, man. Ronda's not getting fined or suspended. Wait, is Sonya about to be fired?
As for your inappropriate treatment of Naomi, you must face the consequences of your actions. You are not to lay a hand on Naomi in any way tonight, especially as it pertains to the championship match with Charlotte Flair.
Ooh, okay, all right.
And it concludes, if you disobey me, your job will be in serious jeopardy.
All right, Sonya. And here comes Naomi. Oh, her night just got worse. Well, Sonya Deville is going to have to walk on eggshells now. Vinnie Mac is looking at her under the microscope, and her job could be in serious jeopardy if she lays a hand on Naomi. That's a way to start off Friday Night Smackdown. You guys like that? Thumbs up, thumbs down, fist emoji. Let me know right here in the live chat. So, welcome, my friends. Welcome one, welcome all. I hope you guys are having a wonderful evening. Let's get right into this thing because it is time for... Oh. Actually, I thought it was time for a roll call, but it's actually time for Naomi to speak.
What's the matter, Sonya? You never got ripped a new one by your boss before?
Ooh.
You know, the funny thing is, Mr. McMahon said you can't lay a hand on me.
Didn't say anything about the other way.
But he never said I can't lay a hand on you.
Oh, and she just slapped her. That's your boss. Yo, she's still your boss. Yo. That's actually... Wow. All of a sudden, Naomi just slapping her boss across the face. Get wrecked, Sonya. Get wrecked. Well, however, let's just say this much. If Sonya does end up suspending or firing Naomi in some way, shape, or form in the future, she has a just cause because, Naomi, you can't just go around slapping your boss. All right, I don't care how terrible of a person they are. I had a terrible boss for 4 years when I worked at a provincial park. That does not mean I got to walk up to his door and say, hey, John, didn't mean I could do that. No, I couldn't. Okay, now it's time for it, though, my friends. It is time for your Con Man Certified Roll Call. So who do we got in here today? We got Carlos Romero. How you doing, buddy? We got Bad Guy Falcon. We have Kelvin Jackson. Welcome to the stream. We have Samuel Vlogs. How you doing? We have Cowboy 420. Welcome. WWE Clips is in here. We got Trey Lucado. I see Big Tiger. Mr. Canadian is in here. We have Zach Guidry. How you doing, my friend? We also have Austin Fritz in here. We have Ryan Vesquez. Welcome to the stream. We have Jason Barker. Good to see you, Barkman. Could I call you Barkman? I'm going to call you Barkman. We also have November Freeze up in here. We got TCS Gaming. Jinx, you owe me a Coke. How you doing? We have Matthew Grantland in here as well. We have Daryl Bill. Bill, I like that name. B-Y-L-L. B to the Y to the L to the L. How you doing, Bill? We got J-Money Jeff in here. Tyrone Darby. Brendan YouTube as well. So many great people. Thank you for being in here. We got Seductive Power. That is a seductive name. And let's finish it off with King of Fate and Mr. Tornicane. Welcome, everyone. All right. So today's stream looks like it's going to be a fun one. We are going to be live for all of SmackDown, all of Rampage, and we're checking out Reddit after the show. So that is all happening right here on this channel, right during this live stream. So you got about 3.5 hours of live streams here tonight with this channel. But then we're going to be continuing on over to Con Games, where we are streaming a brand new game. It is the launch day today. Lost Ark, it is out, and we are going to be checking that after this stream. All right, my friends, so make sure you join us. Lost Ark over on Con Games. It's going to be a fun night tonight. Lots of streams for you. Lots of action. But let's transition over to the new day. Let's do it. Kofi Kingston, Big E. But one thing you should take really big note of is that Kofi and Big E not rocking the same gear. Not rocking the same gear as each other. But this one's going to be interesting. Big E and Kofi Kingston versus Los Lotharios. If I'm not mistaken, yeah. This match happened last week, and it was a banger of a match last week. Seriously, Los Lotharios looked really good. Yes, it's a rematch, but you know what? I think I'm okay with it. As long as they produce the type of match that they had last week, if it's a banger, if it's really well done, if they give them the time in the ring, I am here for it. However, it is a rematch, so we have to be fair. If it's a rematch, it's slightly lazy. You could have done something different, you know? I mean, people might be up in arms if you gave them Angel Garza versus Kofi Kingston in the ring, but at the same time, that's a pretty semi-interesting matchup, and if you're building towards a feud, then you could have next week, you know, you go Humberto Carrillo versus Big E. And then if you wanted to have another tag match eventually, then you could lead to that one. It's a way that you could get to it. Instead, they just decided to throw the rematch out there. But we know as of last week, they put on a great matchup. I wasn't live to watch it with you guys, but they put on an excellent matchup last week. And it was solid, man. Did you guys enjoy the match between the New Day and Los Lotharios last week? Yes or no in the live chat right now. What'd you think? Randy Sam says SmackDown needs MSK. That's true. You know what? I think MSK is main roster ready. If I'm not mistaken, I actually released a tweet from this past Tuesday. Is that what it was? Yeah, literally, right here. Right here. MSK are main roster ready. Just like that. That was back on February 8th. So is that last week? No, that was just this past Tuesday. So that's like 3 days ago. Yeah, I was, I'm right on board with MSK as well. I think those guys are excellent. They could add a lot to any tag team division that they are in, but certainly the SmackDown tag team division, they remind me of a young Hardy Boys. And I know people are going to raise their eyebrows at me because I've been making a lot of comparisons. First Wardlow becoming the next Batista, and then somehow comparing Jade to Goldberg. And now I'm saying MSK is like the next version of the Hardy Boys, but it's not necessarily the next version, but they remind me of the Hardy Boys. They're just different. And I like that about MSK. You know, I like that they have the hand symbol. If you think about it, the Hardy Boys, right? They had the hand symbol. What is it? This is Matt Hardy and this is Jeff Hardy, right? They had their hand symbols. They just remind me of them. So what do you guys think? Do you agree with me? Do you see MSK as a potential main roster act that reminds you of the Hardy Boys? Are they something different? What do you think? Let me know right here in the live chat. Ghostface says, should I tell you this match I found out that's meant to be announced for Elimination Chamber for tonight, or should I not? Nah, let's leave spoilers away from it. We'll find out by the end of the show. Basically, the way that I like running our shows here is if there's any spoilers that are out there, 9 times out of 10, we will find out if they were rumors or if they were true by the end of the show. You know what I mean? If there's something planned for tonight, then we find out within the next 2 hours. And if there's not something planned for tonight, then we will find out when they tell us. I'm not a big fan of listening to rumors. I'm not a big fan of listening to the speculation out there. Unless it's the fun speculation as to who's going to show up tonight because they tease a possible debut. You know what I mean? Could be a contract signing tonight, but I have no idea what the match is. Okay, no problem. I will not say. Sounds good, buddy. They aren't exact replicas, but they do remind me about them. That's in reference to MSK. Jamie Todd says, Con, first of all, are MSK even brothers? They don't have to be. They still remind me of the Hardys. But they are not. Randy Sam says, Con man, what tag team will you call up on SmackDown in your opinion? MSK. Right there, MSK. Ross Block says, the big name is going to be Veer. Could I imagine? God, Veeramania is running wild. But we got a couple donations over here. We have Carlos Romero dropping a $3.16 donation. Thank you, my friend. He says, how's Tucky today? Tucky has been a little bit of a dick, if I'm being honest. My hands are, you can't really see because of the webcam, but like my hands are just completely, yeah, you really can't see on the webcam, can you? Nah, you really can't see, but you can see a little bit up there. I've got some teeth marks. I've got some scrape marks underneath there. I've got some chew marks there. You really can't see on the webcam. That's incredible. But yeah, my hands look like they're completely torn up. I look like I had a really rough night in Vegas. You know what I mean? But there's Los Lotharios. What is that promo? The sexy gouds. Bad Guy Falcon says, Tucker is not that bad. You know what? No, okay. I understand. He's a puppy. He was just being a dick today. That's all it was. He actually had a really good day today up until about 4:30 p.m. And then he just started losing his shit. It was a tough day after that point. But up until then, he was great. He was really well behaved. Wait, what the hell are the Los Lotharios doing? Are they like, are they being, yo, they're almost sick to their stomachs because they're looking at the fans in attendance? Come on. Oh, what the hell? It's a kiss cam. No! No, 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 no. Oh, my God. Los Lotharios kiss cam. What the fuck? No. 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 Oh, my good fucking Lord. Oh, now they're just going to kiss a girl there in the front row. All right, then. All right, then. Kiss cam with Los Lotharios. You gotta be joking, though. What do you guys think about the kiss cam? Thumbs up, thumbs down, fist emoji here in the live chat. Wow. That's, Oh, there's the girl again. That girl was very, very happy. She was extremely, extremely happy to get the kiss in there. Okay, so, my friends, let's get the poll up here asking you, the viewers, who will win? It's either going to be Los Lotharios or it's going to be Big E. So, who? Nice plant, says Steve Taylor. This one right there? Yeah. Yeah, we should name that plant. Guys, what should the name of that plant be right there? What do you think? Anyways, get your votes in. Do vote one for Los Lotharios. Vote two for New Day. Mitch. Mitch, yeah, that's the one. That's the one, Mitch. Yeah, it's Mitch, the potted plant. Of course it is. Of course it freaking is. Yeah, it's Mitch. Yep. Oh, Mitch, the potted plant. God, I got to pull him up on the screen now. Mitch, the potted plant. Mitch. Moment of silence here for Mitch. Our good old boy, Ambrose, and his potted plant, Mitch. R.I.P. to Mitch. The rare ficus. He's a legend in the business, isn't he? Gone too soon. Gone but not forgotten. Can we get a Mitch chant in the live chat? Mitch, 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 Mitch. Oh, nice move right there. Now a tag has been made. Big E and Kofi Kingston looking to work together. Off the ropes. Ooh, and Kofi just takes down both men. Los Lotharios got lost. Dropped. Anyways. LOL, wasn't that Chris Jericho's plant? I think it was Ambrose, right? It was on the Ambrose Asylum, and then I think Jericho destroyed the plant. Or whatever Ambrose's talk show was, where he just had, like, one single board in the ring, and, like, I think that's what it was. Ambrose. Yeah, Ambrose. I said that, right? Anyways, we got a couple more donations right here. We got Natalie Rybanko says, where is Pat McAfee? You know what? I don't know. I don't know where Pat McAfee is. It's a good question. Oh, by the way, everyone, Keith Lee's new theme song? Yeah, we have it updated right now. So if you guys wanted to drop a $15 donation for the Keith Lee song, that's what you will hear is his brand new banger of a theme. And I like the donation. I think you guys will as well, because I think it would be lots of fun in the chat. So if you wanted to check that out, make sure you do so. But we got Natalie dropping this $5. Thank you, girl. Pat is in LA for the Super Bowl. There you go. That makes sense. Apparently, they addressed it on the show. I miss a lot of things on commentary. I just can't hear over myself talking, if I'm being honest. Pat McAfee. And also, I have the stream turned down pretty low because otherwise it loops back through my microphone. So, yeah. We got Jason Barker right here.
Speaking of bosses, I'm lucky because my boss happens to be my partner and we make decisions together.
That's good, bud. Congratulations once again on the raise and the moving forward in your career there, Jason. It's good to see, buddy. Good to see. Who is Josh Allen? Quarterback. Buffalo. Bills. I think that Bask in His Glory is better than his current theme, but his current theme does slap. Yeah, definitely. We'll wait and see. I think that this one has potential for people to be loud AF. If you look at some of the theme songs they have in AEW, they have the fans chanting along or singing along. And I think the one that Keith Lee has right now is going to have a lot of fans chanting, I am Lee. I am Lee. I am Lee. You know, or the fans collectively will all say, Lee. And it'll almost be like a Moose thing. You know how when Moose enters, everybody chants, Moose. Dan da dan da dan da dan da dan Moose. Dan da dan da dan da dan da dan Moose. I have a feeling that this Lee thing is going to be very similar. Very similar. I am Lee. I am Lee. You know, it's something like that. It's going to be fun. Can't wait. What are your thoughts on Mr. Kennedy? I thought he was underrated and he deserved that push when he returned before Randy got involved. He was good on the microphone. Good on the microphone, decent in the ring from what I remember. But you know what? Here's my opinion on this, okay? If somebody is that level, like people say that, you know, like, oh my God, they missed a superstar in Mr. Kennedy. You might be right if they positioned him as Vince McMahon's son-in-law or whatever it was, or illegitimate son. That's what the story was, the illegitimate storyline. If they gave that to him, he had a chance. But you have to admit that everywhere else that he's been just kind of there. He's never been over as the guy. He's always been essentially the number three, number four, number five, number six guy anywhere he's gone. Very rarely is he the number one, two, or three guy. You know, I would say he's your number four face and probably like a number three heel. You know, maybe a number three heel. But like you're not rooting for Mr. Anderson, or you weren't back in the day. Like, not legitimately. And there was better baby faces back in the day, and there was better heels back in the day. You know, he was a solid act. There's no question about it. The whole microphone coming down thing with the Mr. Kennedy. Kennedy. It was good. Doesn't make you a world champion. And, you know, maybe it would have been fun with him being paired with Vince McMahon. Maybe it would have sucked. You know, he never became the star, the guy anywhere else. So I can't say he was a giant missed opportunity. I say we got a good run from him, and it would have been interesting to see where it led. But that's about it. Randy was pathetic back then. It says on a news article that after a botched belly-to-back suplex, Orton got him fired. Yeah, that, like, something went down with Randy Orton and Mr. Kennedy. There is no doubt about that back in the day. But also, ask yourself this question. Is one botched move from a guy who has been positioned as being maybe a future star of the company, who is getting a solid push, getting matches against The Undertaker, and I think wins against, or a win against The Undertaker or something on pay-per-view? I can't exactly remember. Maybe two losses. He had a couple matches with The Undertaker on pay-per-view. You don't position a guy like that and then fire him for one botched move. There was obviously more stuff to it that obviously has never came out, or I'm not aware that has come out. There's just, what, without a doubt, there's more to it than just that. Anyways, let's talk a little bit about this match that is underway, because Angel Garza just hit a beautiful moonsault on Big E. And now Humberto Carrillo with a moonsault of his own. Oh my God! He lands it on Kofi. No way! Two! Oh! Ho, 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 ho. For a second there, I thought Kofi was done. Damn, that was close. Man. Now going all the way up is Angel Garza. Humberto has Kofi up on his shoulders. Guys, it's a pretty solid matchup again, 2 weeks in a row. Los Lotharios, though, just ran into each other. Right into his little Lotharios. Oh, there it is. The trouble in paradise from Kofi Kingston. Kofi now lining it up on Angel Garza. Angel now caught by Kofi. Rolls him up. Wait a second. Angel Garza right back into the cover too. Oh, my God. What? Oh, my God. Los Lotharios just beat the New Day. Wow. That's a huge win for the Los Lotharios, but I don't know if that's the right call. What do you guys think? Good or bad call? Definitely unexpected.
Tomorrow at the Elimination Chamber Premium Live event, the Viking Raiders. Erik, after your tough loss to Jimmy Uso last week, how will you rebuild momentum heading into your championship match?
Look, at Elimination Chamber.
Oh, what the frig now? The Usos? Oh, shoot. Usos attacking the Viking Raiders backstage. Well. God, man. Oh, they're going to steal their helmets now? Oh, no. Whoa. Oh my God, they stole their helmets. Oh, what are they gonna do? Oh, call the freaking cops. They stole their helmets. Oh my Lord. Oh, whoa. Big storyline development there. Anyways, Roman was just shown on the TV. God, man. How uneventful that was. How uneventful. You know what they, you know literally what they did? They were just like, hey, you know what we're going to do? We're going to have the Usos steal the Viking Raiders helmets. That's what we're going to do. Doesn't matter if we write the segment to be anything more than just that. No, no, no. It's just the Viking Raiders. We're going to have them interview. And then it's going to be like, you're 5 seconds into the interview. Count it down. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And then you're going to get attacked. You don't even get to say any words, really. It's just, boom, kick to the face. And then, ha, 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 I got your helmet. Like, that's pretty much what it was. Middle school shit. Middle school shit. Granted, if one of you stole my hat, I'd be pissed. All right? I'd be pissed. I would. I would want it back. I'd be like, yo, give me my hat back. And you'd be like, no. And then I'd be like, what? It's my hat. Give it back. And you're like, no. And I'm like, what? It's my hat. Give me my hat. And then if you say no again, then we got problems, I would assume. But it's... Yeah. Just did something. Yeah. I don't know. Do you guys like storylines where it's just somebody stole my thing and I want it back? Because it didn't work for me with the Drew McIntyre storyline with the stolen sword. Doesn't work with the stolen helmets for me. I mean, it's just... what else has been stolen? There's been so many things just stolen through the years. Jericho's light-up jacket being stolen. But here's the thing. If you're going to actually do a theft storyline, at least make it like... You know, with the Drew McIntyre stolen sword, at least they tried to say, hey, this sword means a lot to Drew McIntyre. It means a lot, and so if somebody steals it, he's gonna want it back because it has some sentimental value to him. The fucking Viking Raiders just wear helmets and they just have horns on them. Are you seriously gonna be like, I want that back? You're gonna be like, no, give me a new helmet with new horns. I'm okay. It's just a helmet with horns. Who freaking cares? Creative department, give me a new helmet with horns. Like, at least Drew McIntyre had a reason why he would want his helmet or want his sword back. Viking Raiders wanting their helmets back? Who freaking cares? The stolen egg. Oh my God, that's right. The stolen egg. Vinnie Mac wanted his stolen egg back. That went... I mean, at least it was a way to get Austin Theory and Vinnie Mac together, eh? With the recent Reigns-Rollins feud revolving around the end of the Shield, imagine what Ambrose would be doing if he hadn't retired to help run El Generico's orphanage in Mexico, right? Right, man? He should be here wrestling. Ambrose, guys. Like, I don't know where Ambrose is these days. Freaking Dean Ambrose just fell off the face of the map. I heard about this Mox guy. He looks a lot like him. It's actually kind of crazy, and he seems to have a girlfriend or a wife, I'm pretty sure. It's something like that. That seems to be very familiar, and I recognize her. And I, if I'm not mistaken, Ambrose might have dated her at one point, but it's just very weird. I don't know where Ambrose is these days, but God, man, this Mox guy has stolen his gimmick, no doubt about it. And he's made it better, too, which is just the weird part, right? He's going to have to sue this guy for gimmick infringement or something. King of Fate says, I don't think that's Ambrose, though. They must be twins. Yeah, you know what, dude? I don't know, man. I don't know if they're twins or not. I feel like it's just a dude who happens to look really like Ambrose. That's what I think. On January 1st, 2023, who do I think will be WWE AEW champions? I'm going to say MJF will be the AEW champion. For WWE, no idea. I don't think WWE has WrestleMania planned out, let alone next year planned out. So at this point, it would just be a crapshoot. What would my reaction be if Goldberg defeated Roman? This. Are you fucking kidding? That's pretty much what it would be. If that happens, my God, man. Woo! A fairy tale ending says there is this guy, Sami Zayn, who looks mighty like El Generico. He has the beard and everything. Probably not, though. El Generico is in Mexico. Yeah, I mean, dude, that's just pure speculation at this point. There is no way Sami Zayn and El Generico are the same person. Sami Zayn doesn't wear a mask. Come on.
Premium live event. Now, last week on Friday Night SmackDown, we saw the reemergence of an icon.
Oh, come on. Don't call me an icon. I'm just special counsel to the tribal chief.
Well, I was actually talking about Goldberg.
Goldberg? You talking about Goldberg?
Yes, Goldberg, the Hall of Famer. The man who once won 173 straight matches in WCW. Went on to beat the immortal Hulk Hogan to win the WCW Championship.
Make sure you guys leave a like on this video if you're enjoying the stream. And if you would like to, you can always drop a Super Chat donation.
That's pretty good. If I was in WCW, everyone would be winning. Because they'd still be in business.
Wow.
Hurry up. Let's go.
Roman saying if he was in WCW, they would have still been in business. Holy cow.
In fact, let's talk about what Goldberg accomplished a few years ago at Survivor Series. When he defeated the Beast Brock Lesnar in 86 seconds.
I was there live, guys. I was literally there live. It was the most surreal experience, watching Goldberg squash Brock Lesnar in the main event. legit, the pay-per-view ended at like 10:30. It was like 10:36 or something like that, and the show was over. People in the stands were getting up, walking out, being like, that's it? It's over? And like when the lights came on and they left, it was legitimately like, are you kidding? That was the show? Like, that was the end? It was surreal. It was one of the most insane moments because nobody did expect it. I will admit that. It was insane. And I was there.
Brock Lesnar's old news. The farmer, the butcher, he's old news. The guy in my shadow, old news. Does anyone even care? Does anyone even care about him?
I don't care about him. I love my tribal chief.
Defending. Who wants to be introduced that way anyway? Imagine the maniacal ego this man has.
Wow.
Two-time Universal Champion. Nobody cares. Wonder why? Because I'm here now.
Wow.
I'm the greatest Universal Champion of all time. No one has done the things that I've done in over 35 years. And if that guy came back around, I smack him in the face and get him out of here, too. You understand?
Shit.
You understand? Next question.
This match between you and Goldberg was supposed to take place 2 years ago at WrestleMania. It never happened. Finally, we get this match next Saturday. Is there any added pressure on you?
Not at all.
Ooh.
I'd say all the pressure's on Goldberg. Because 2 years ago, he might have a chance. Everything's different now.
I like that.
The world's changed. I've changed. I'm the head of the table now. Your tribal chief is untouchable, Cole.
Nice.
Smashed everyone. Like I said before, the greatest of all time. I'm going to smash Goldberg. As a matter of fact,
damn.
Ladies and gentlemen, what you're about to hear
is not a prediction. It's a spoiler.
This is a good promo, guys. Do you like it? Thumbs up in the chat if you like it.
I'm going to Goldberg. Goldberg.
Oh, ho. I'm going to Goldberg. Goldberg. Yo, is Roman going to beat Goldberg in like... I would love to see that. Oh my god, I would love to see that. Roman Reigns, Goldberg, Goldberg. Beat him like in less than 2 minutes. I want to see that now. Give it to me, please. Have that be the opening match. Have Roman just go out there and smash Goldberg. All right, let's get those fingers up if you acknowledge the tribal chief up in the air. Way up there. And also, my friends, if you are really enjoying this show and you want to support the channel, you can consider dropping a Super Chat donation. We're going to be live for the remainder of SmackDown, all of Rampage, and we're going to also check out the Reddit tonight. Then we're heading on over to Con Games to play some Lost Ark. So we've got lots of hours of live streams for you guys here tonight. We probably got about 5 hours, 5.5 hours in total here for you. So it's going to be a great evening. Make sure you check us out. So what is this dungeon match? I don't know why they gave him the dungeon style showdown. Maybe because Natalya is the last person from the Heart Dungeon. But this is just apparently a pinfall or submissions match. That's the only way this can end. So it's just another way to, I guess, promote the match. But it's a dungeon match. Would have been neat if they maybe had, like, the ring enclosed somehow. Not like a steel cage, but just like, you know, like, here would be the idea. You've got your ring, right? And just put, like, some barricades on the outside so you can't go over the top rope. You have to remain in the ring at all times, but it's not a steel cage. You know, there's not that added element of the cage and jumping off the top. It's just a dungeon match. You can't leave. Could be interesting. Maybe there's something to work off of there. No DQs and countouts. There we go. No DQ. Yeah, sounds like no DQ. Yeah, no DQ. So it can only end via pinfall or submissions. No DQ, no countouts. Unless the referee can stop it, I don't know, right? Because I thought Hell in a Cell was supposed to be no DQs, no count outs, no nothing like that. But apparently the ref can just stop the match if it gets too violent. News to me. Luck 7, how you doing, buddy? He says Luckhausen is here. Ah, very evil. Nice. Very here. Very evil. Ross Block says, if Aliyah wins by submission, when she will have beaten Natalya in every single way. Good point. Maybe that will be a thing here this evening. Roy Ress says, Con Man, what is my favorite beer? You know what? You know what I almost just said? I almost said MDK. MGD is what I meant to say here. So MGD, Miller Genuine Draft, is my favorite. Very lucky, very evil. Yes, very, very lucky. Very, very evil. I guess no Sasha tonight, says AJ. Potentially not. She's not on the card as of right now. Richard Finch says Owen Hart and Ken Shamrock had a dungeon match. Did they? Okay, so I didn't know this was a match that had happened in the past. So that's pretty cool. Do I have the mini fridge next to me? Kind of. It's over in the corner. It's somewhat close to me. What are my thoughts on Impact Wrestling last night? Haven't caught up to what happened on Impact last night yet. I'll have to check that out at some point. Entrance fans have more leverage than in-ring talent fans do. Don't know what that means. Con, to be honest, I don't care for Brock versus Roman at Mania. Why is that? Is it just because you've seen it a few too many times? Is that your thought process? If so, I get it. I totally get it. Hey, Con Man, Isaac Yankum in the Hall of Fame, right? He should get inducted. Yeah, you know what? That dude was famous for pulling teeth and kicking ass, let me tell you. Macho Studios says, that's the worst beer, Con. You're the worst type of beer. How am I? I'm doing good. Am I liking the Ring of Honor Impact Invasion storyline? I'll be honest with you, have not kept up to date with it enough to make a comment on that. Not quite yet. Wonder what happened to Isaac Yankum, right? I heard he's a mayor somewhere. I might be wrong, though. Oh, yeah, that's right. Connor from the Ascension, known as Big Con, showed up in Impact Wrestling. I did see that against Josh Alexander. It's pretty neat. Watched MLW yesterday. Karrion Kross is heading to MLW? Is he? Yo, didn't know about that. That's some news. Cool. But here comes Natalya. So let's get this poll up here on the screen. I want to know from you guys, who do you think is going to win? How's the fur baby? He's okay. He's okay. I mean, he's happy, but he's been biting us a lot. So we're really trying to figure out a way to nip the biting because it's bad. It hurts. You know, he's drawn blood on us a few times. Drawn blood a few times. You can kind of see my hand there. It's just a little bit. Like, those are teeth marks right there. And then the scrape marks don't really show up on the webcam, but they're there. I love them, though. Natalya. So Natalya, or will it be Aliyah? Aliyah. I hope I spelled her name right. All right, so dungeon match is officially underway. Only ends via pinfall or submission. So you have to make your opponent tap out, or you have to pin their shoulders to the mat. 1, 2, 3. There is no disqualifications. There is no countouts. The only way to win, once again, is by pinfall or submission. Try a chew toy, Con Man. Oh, Roy Ress. Oh, buddy. You should see our downstairs. The amount of chew toys that we've got for him already is insane. Oh, Aliyah blows a little kiss there to Natalya. And there's a back elbow attempt, but Natalya sends her right off the ropes. Leapfrog right up and over. Oh, Aliyah rolls right through that one. Okay. All right, Aliyah. Rolls through now. Natalya's shoulders are down. Count of two and a kick out. Anyways, guys, what do you think of Aliyah? Are you a fan of her at the moment? still hasn't quite clicked for me the way that I hoped. I've been following her for a long time. She was on the Breaking Ground series back in the WWE Network, I think back in 2014 or 2015, something like that. She was on that series. She's been around for a long time. Been down in NXT for a while, was part of a tag team, I think Bad and Bougie, or Born and Bougie, that's what it was. Bad and Bougie, yeah. The song, Born and Bougie. It was a part of a tag team there. Didn't really advance with that. Robert Stonebrand didn't really do much that way. But she's still only like 26 or 27 years old, so she's got a lot to go. But I just haven't quite connected with the Canadian Aliyah yet. Oh, what is this? Trying to make Natalya tap out. Well, that's interesting. Single leg Boston Crab against Natalya, one of the greatest submission experts in the women's division. You're not going to make her tap out like that. Natalya floats her over into the sharpshooter. And Aliyah, you're going to have to tap out. Aliyah is done. Aliyah is done, man. Absolutely. Wait a second, though. Aliyah still clawing? What? No way. You're joking me. Oh, but there's no rope breaks in this one. Oh, Aliyah taps out. Well, that's that. That's that one. So Natalya beats her. All right. That's probably the right call. Natalya is the bigger star. Oh, come on. Come on, Natalya. Aliyah doesn't deserve that. Just attacking her now. Uh-oh. Oh, wait a second. Xia Li's going to come on out. That's what I'm talking about. Here we go. It's Xia. I'm surprised she didn't take the time to do her little entrance, right? Like, somebody's getting beat up in the ring and she didn't take a moment to go, ha! No, instead, she just ran right after Natalya and started punching her right in the face. That'd be Xia Li. I think this girl's a lot to offer. Great first feud for her. Man, nice spinning kick as well, and gets her out of the ring. So the Protecta is here. Now kick Aliyah's head off. Do it. Just kick Aliyah's head off. Ah. They didn't do it. She protects. I just now found out she's the Protector. Yeah, that's her nickname. It's what they've called her. So are we going to see a tag team of Xia Li and Aliyah potentially go for the tag team titles? You know what? I wouldn't hate that. Would you guys like to see that? That would be something for the women's tag division. Be something. Thank you, Mr. LH. He says, showing support from the UK. Attaboy, buddy. Been a member for 17 months as well. Thank you so freaking much. Your support is seriously appreciated. As is everybody else's, you know? Like, we talk a lot about how this channel does not have access to the ads after the streams because of all the songs that we play. So our members keep us afloat. Our Super Chat donators keep us afloat. And it's not all about the money at all. Obviously, the money allows me to do this on a weekly basis and just be here every single night with you guys and produce the content that I do. But it is not about that. It is about the content. It is about the conversations. It is about what we discuss in this chat room and the great times that we develop together. So I just appreciate whether you guys just stopped by for a minute or have been watching for freaking 10 years almost. Thank you for your viewership. Thank you for spending your nights with me. We've been doing WWE stuff for like, what, 4 and a bit years, maybe even longer. It's been an incredible run. And I don't plan on stopping anytime soon. So seriously, thank you. There's been some people who have literally spent every single Monday and every single Friday and all the pay-per-views with me since I did Royal Rumble 2017, which is insane. What? 2018, 2019, 2020, 21, 22. Like, we 5 years. Freaking 5 years. Not 4 years. 5 years. It's insane, guys. So thank you so much for being here. And thank you so much for spending your evenings with me. All I ask in exchange is a like on this video. That's all I ask, truly. Anything else is just extra. It'll be 4 years for me on this channel in 2 months. Amazing, man. Amazing. God, 4 years already. This is crazy. That's insane, bud. They're mentioning The Rock right now. Con, what match that has never happened would I like to have seen in the past or potentially in the future? Even wrestlers who have died versus current wrestlers now. You're opening up a lot of possibilities. Matches that would be really cool to see. You know, you can start with Andre versus Big Show. That would have been really neat to see. Then you can go down the path of Shawn Michaels versus AJ Styles. That would have been insane. Personally, I would have loved to see Shawn Michaels versus Dolph Ziggler because they're two of my favorites of all time. Sting versus Undertaker is one of those matches I would have loved to see. And also, you know what? People don't talk about it enough, but a dream matchup would have been John Cena versus Hulk Hogan. That would have been an absolute dream match. And as much as we might not enjoy Hulk Hogan in 2022, you cannot deny the fact that for a long, 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 long time there, that dude was a mega draw and the biggest name in the business and synonymous with wrestling. So, like, John Cena versus Hulk Hogan would have been insane to see. Hell, while we're at it, you might as well throw in Roman Reigns versus Bruno Sammartino. Holy shit. Talk about two of the greatest stars of their generations going at it. That would be amazing. It would be amazing to see happen. Legit amazing. You talk about... Man, when... I don't think we got to see this match, and I hope someday we get to see it. Daniel Bryan versus Pete Dunne. I think in many ways Pete Dunne is the yin to the yang of Daniel Bryan. Or I said that wrong. The yin to Daniel Bryan's yang. That would be an amazing match. And then you take a look at like some people that have come through the business. Kurt Angle versus like... anybody on the roster right now. Think about Kurt Angle and Shawn Michaels, the classic match that they had at WrestleMania 21. Now I'm blanking. Yeah, WrestleMania 21. Cool, I got it right. Hey, look at that. I know my wrestling history. That match was one of the greatest matches ever. Like, seriously, just a bona fide... banger, banger, banger of a match that had everything that you could possibly want in it in terms of an actual wrestling match. Imagine Kurt Angle versus, like, God. Well, Chad Gable jumps right to mind immediately. Though, freaking, I will never forgive them for not making Chad Gable the half-son of Kurt Angle. Like, oh, man, and no offense to Jason Jordan, who, by the way, I think was criminally underrated during his run. No offense to him at all, but my goodness, Gable, it would have been magic. It would have been money. So much so that I still really hope that they bring back Kurt Angle to be with Gable and Otis. The Alpha Academy, man. Like, it'd be cool. It would. But also, we cannot deny the fact that Jason Jordan, his stuff against Seth Rollins was leading to some good stuff, in my opinion. I know some people didn't like it, but he was generating some really solid heat, if I remember correctly. Con, based off what I see, my first WWE stream on this channel was SmackDown in 2016. If I'm not mistaken, my first ever stream was the draft in 2016. The WWE draft, I think, was my first time going live. And I got 100K or 80K views or something like that. It was one of those streams that just did really freaking well. And that's how I became a WWE streamer. Then it slowed down a little bit after I got a copyright strike for SummerSlam 2016. Yeah, because I reached 10,000 subscribers at NXT TakeOver Brooklyn the night before SummerSlam 2016. And then got slammed with a copyright strike that night of SummerSlam. And then... I was off until TLC 2016, and then I think my channel really blew up as the Royal Rumble 2017 came around. That's when this channel really just started growing, and I think we went from like 10,000 subscribers to 26,000 subs or something ridiculous like that in one single night. It was crazy. So Johnny Knoxville, oh, did he just sign a Sami? Oh, he just said, no, Johnny Knoxville. Sammy's not a loser. Sami Zayn forever. Oh, it's a pun on Jackass. I never got that for the t-shirt for Sami. Why does it say Johnny Knoxville, a WWE World Champ? Now he's putting it into a freaking wood chipper. The shirt just goes flying out of the wood chipper. He's got a... I like... Oh my god, Johnny Knoxville has the world championship across his back, and he's wearing the freaking United States title. He's not even wearing a world title. My god, Johnny.
Right there. Because jackass man Johnny Knoxville has already spent way too much time getting in my head, and I think I need to start focusing on the task at hand, like reclaiming my Intercontinental Championship. And in the short term, hosting my live podcast, Inzayn. This is Inzayn. Welcome to the show. I am your host,
Waleed. Welcome to Team Green, buddy.
Okay, we're going to... No booing. The audio, you're going to ruin the audio, so please. Now, we're going to be discussing some really intellectual things tonight. We're going to have a lengthy discussion on the subjective nature of human consciousness, but don't worry, I did dumb it down for you people. I'm going to offer some vegan Creole recipes for the people of New Orleans. Don't worry. Yeah, yeah. Food good.
Oh. Here comes Boogs. Hail. Rick Boogs. Shinsuke Nakamura. Here he comes, the Intercontinental Champion, Shinsuke Nakamura. What an intro. Do you guys like Nakamura and Boogs together? Give me a thumbs up or a thumbs down in this live chat, or a fist emoji if you're somewhere in between. Wasn't he supposed to fight Nakamura? What happened to that? He goes from world title to IC title to Knoxville? I honestly don't know what is happening. We will find out in this segment, I would assume. The Intercontinental Championship has lost its value, in my opinion. The Miz made it seem so legit, made it feel like the top title. Yeah, it's not from a lack of effort from Nakamura. Seriously, they've been keeping him strong. I just don't know if fans are as hot on this act as I think WWE wants them to be. There's nothing wrong with the act. It's actually really solid.
Live audio. Shinsuke Nakamura. Please have a seat. Hey, I'm actually really shocked, even though you rudely interrupted me. I'm pretty shocked that you actually showed up. Because for over 6 weeks, I have been number one contender for that Intercontinental Championship. And you have been... ducking me.
There it is. Bringing it back. Okay, guys.
You've been ducking me, but it doesn't matter because next week we finally go one-on-one for the Intercontinental Championship.
There you go.
I can't wait to see the look on your face. Yeah. Yeah, yeah.
Put the title on Sami. Have a one-on-one match between him and Knoxville for the IC title. I know fans will hate it, but do it.
My championship.
Just have Sami squash Knoxville somehow.
You think I don't
or have the
you
entire cast. Oh my god,
you.
They would totally put the you title on Knoxville, wouldn't they? Never mind, don't do it. Knoxville. Don't do it. No, don't do it. Don't do it. They would put the title on Knoxville. They'd have the entire cast come down to the ring, somehow get involved in the match, somehow use a cattle prod to electrocute Sami Zayn, and then the title will change hands to Johnny Knoxville. Don't do it. No, no, don't do it. Don't do it. Don't do it. I'm wrong. Okay, bad idea from Khan. Don't do it.
Did you see the movie?
Did I see the movie, What Jackass Forever? In case you didn't notice, I got thrown off the red carpet premiere in Hollywood.
No, Sami, no, Sami. The movie they're making next week called Jackass Defeated.
Nice! It means you!
No idea what...
Oh, is that funny? You find that funny, do you? Yeah. You know, this whole thing is funny because Nakamura, I used to have so much respect for you. You once had the great Liberator Sami Zayn in your corner, and now you go from me to him? To this meathead? To this shaved gorilla with a guitar?
Wow.
Let me tell you something, Rick Boobs, okay? You could lift all the weights in the world. You could do your little military presses. You could do your bench. You could do your deads. And you can play your guitar all day long, doing all the...
Thanks, Sami! Shut up!
Wow. Boobs!
Let me tell you something.
Oh my god, what happened? Oh my god, Boogs, are you okay? Oh my goodness.
What the fuck just happened? Did Boogs just get electrocuted? What in the blue hell? And Sami Zayn hits the Huluva kick on Nakamura. What the hell just happened? I am so incredibly confused.
That's really a shame.
As Nakamura was attempting to... Oh, like, what in the... It looked like when he touched the microphone, his hand got electrocuted. Boogs is... Oh my god, is Boogs not going to be able to play guitar anymore? Yo, did... Oh, shit. Did Boogs just maybe lose the ability to play guitar? He is holding his hand out. He's holding his right hand out, like, big time. Guys, he actually might just lost his ability to play the guitar. Interesting. Okay, so... Zero NCTXCR says, stop complaining about everything and just enjoy it, my God. I'm going to say the same thing to you. Stop complaining about me complaining about something and just enjoy it. Why does one person complaining about maybe a minor thing affect your enjoyment of the show? That's my question to you. Just watch the show if you're worried about it. And if you don't like my thoughts on it, you don't have to watch me. However, I'm very glad that you do watch me. And I hope that you can have a civil discussion with us about things that you might have enjoyed that we might not have, and vice versa. Whoa.
Clay more? I could use a little clay less.
Dude, I knew you were...
I'm serious.
Oh, he's referring to someone in the chat. Cesaro, my bad. It's very difficult to tell. Sorry about that, Zero. My bad, dude.
The doctor won't medically clear me to fight Drew McIntyre at Elimination Chamber. Wouldn't that be a shame, huh?
Fucking Madcap Moss. It's my reaction to Madcap Moss's jokes. They're hilarious. What's the deal with the audio tonight? Is there weird stuff happening with the audio? I'm curious. These freaking comedians, I know, right?
Inches in the curse, weighing in at 285 pounds, Happy Corbin!
people aren't saying there's anything wrong with my audio, so I guess we're fine. I guess. Oh, yo, we're getting Cesaro versus Happy Corbin up next.
Cool.
They seriously going all in on this Happy Corbin gimmick. Yeah, dude, they are. They are. I'll be honest, I really enjoyed when Corbin was down on his luck, like bad luck Corbin. I really enjoyed that. I wish they would have ran with that for a bit longer, but I guess it was just the natural way to get him to a new character. I think they had really, they had an opportunity for Corbin to have him be the laughing stock for a long time of the WWE, like just truly a laughing stock, but then get to the point where people would build up sympathy for him. One thing Corbin has not had yet in the WWE is a face run. And he has the End of Days. He has that finisher. He just lacks the sympathy from the crowd because the crowd truly does not like him. They missed an opportunity, in my opinion, to get Corbin babyface. Yes, this Happy Corbin character is a solid mid-card heel act, but that's all it is it's a solid enough mid-card heel act that is going to be able to go up there against any of the babyfaces and produce some solid enough matches. But if they wanted to try to elevate him more, man, they missed their opportunity, in my opinion. They really do. They really did, I should say. Botch Guy says, this is the worst show of the year, my lord. Wouldn't go that far to say the worst. Oh, I guess the year is young still. Never mind. Is it the worst show of the year? It's been boring. It hasn't been entertaining. It's just been kind of there. Worst show of the year. Worst show of the year. I don't know, guys. Is there other ones that come to mind? I think we had a pretty rough Raw, didn't we? I can't remember. Last week's SmackDown was pretty solid. But Botch Guy, good to see you, buddy. Good to have you. What you doing tonight, man? What you doing? I'm going to go live with Lost Ark at 11:30-ish p.m. So that would be 8:30 p.m. your time. So after Rampage and after we do the Reddit, I'm going live with it. I know, right? Interesting, eh, Botch Guy? Hey? Possibly an open invite there if you want to come on in and join the stream. It's your choice. He says, game is brilliant. I'm so pumped to be able to stream it. I'm so pumped to be able to play it. Have not played it yet, but I've been watching some streams today. I've been watching some videos today, getting ready for the stream tonight. I was actually going to do the stream around launch time today, but they didn't actually end up launching when they were supposed to. It was delayed. Macho says, SmackDown tonight is very boring. Easily the worst SmackDown in months. Well, that was the first hour in 10 minutes. Let's get through the next 50 minutes and see if people still think that it's the worst SmackDown that we've had in a while. We'll see. Randy Sam says, Khan, is Moss turning on Corbin? Not right now. I think eventually Corbin is going to be the one who turns on Moss. Don't know why. Oh, really there, Big Tiger? Well, you're with us tonight again. Young Boy Trey says, Corbin is a good wrestler. They just don't know what to do with his character. Yeah, agreed. Corbin is one of the safer workers in the business. If you watch the way that he works, doesn't do a lot of high-risk maneuvers. A lot of his moves land in the center of the ring, either flat on their stomach or flat on their back. He does a lot of high-impact moves, but that can be taken very easily. His bump count is low, right? He doesn't take a lot of massive bumps. A lot of lifting up, a lot of power stuff, a lot of shots, a lot of striking, but the bumps are easy. I bet you would love to work Corbin. If you're a worker in the WWE, I bet you every time that you see your name next to Corbin, you're like, oh, this is going to be a solid night for me. You know, I'm not going to light the world on fire, but I'm also not going to stink up the joint. He's a very solid worker. Very solid. Riddick Moss is easier to get behind than Madcap Moss. Fair. Maybe they'll switch him back to that eventually. I don't know. But let's get the polls up here asking you, the viewers, who do you think will win? It's either going to be Cesaro or Corbin. Also, Corbin makes use of a lot of rest holds, if you want to call them that. He's got some aggressive moves, but there's a lot of rest holds in between. So who do you think is going to win? Vote Cesaro for vote one or vote two for Happy Corbin? Gradito says, remember when Cesaro fought Roman for the Universal title? Pepperidge Farm remembers. Yeah, we all remember that one. It was a solid enough feud, but it was actually laughable that a lot of people thought Cesaro was taking the title away from Reigns. That he wasn't even close. Wait, now into the deep six. Cover! Cesaro kicks out of that one. Cesaro was competing for the Universal Championship last year against Roman in a very great match, and here he is getting the jobber entrance. Yeah, you know, guys, Cesaro's cold as hell, man. This shouldn't be a shock. What has Cesaro been doing recently? Very, very little. He's been in a throwaway tag team with Ricochet. Why are you guys shocked about this? Definitely not a shocking thing to see him get the jobber entrance tonight. Corbin's been on TV nearly every single week for a long time at this point. Cesaro had one run against Roman. I like Cesaro as much as the next person. He's amazing. He is a bona fide stud in the ring. But come on, you shouldn't be surprised. King of Fate says Cesaro needs to win a world title before retiring. If Mr. Perfect can go an entire career without winning a world title, there's unfortunately going to be people like Cesaro who go their career without winning a world title. You know, if he does win his world title, I will be thrilled. I will be ecstatic. It will be like, yes, Cesaro, you finally did it, bud. But unfortunately, I don't see that in his future. It's going to take a really big push for Cesaro in order to reach that mountaintop. It's almost as if they pushed him just so they could feed him to the guy that they're about to feed to Old Man William. Pretty much. Nice uppercut there by Cesaro and a kick out by Corbin. Jake the Snake never held a world title. There you go. Yeah, people have had amazing careers that have just never, for whatever reason, won the world title. Big boot there from Cesaro. Off the ropes. Clothesline from Corbin. And Corbin just puts his ass to the mat. Here it goes. Yep. And game over. End of days. See ya. Two. Corbin beats Cesaro. Yep. Are you surprised? Nope. Are you sad? Yep. And that's another match here down the drain tonight. Bit of a stinker of an episode. Just a bit of a stinker. But I hope you guys are enjoying the show. If you are, make sure you leave a like on this video. Also making sure you are subscribed to the channel. Just because SmackDown is not that entertaining, hopefully I'm able to put a smile on your face here this evening. I hope. Madcap Moss with his black eye.
I'm having a lot of trouble seeing here. Everything's blurry. There's dark spots in my right visual field. As much as it pains me to say this, I think you gotta cancel my match with Drew McIntyre at Elimination Chamber.
Oh.
I'll need to test your vision. Go ahead and close your eyes for me. Then open your right eye and tell me what you see.
I see a sword.
I see a sword.
Now, I know you're perfectly fine, buddy. So go ahead and tell Mr. Doctor here you're perfectly good to go against Drew McIntyre Elimination Chamber.
The vision is miraculously better. All good.
Thank God. I was worried about you for a second there, buddy, because I was just talking to Adam Pierce. It's no longer just a regular old match we're having. No. The Elimination Chamber, it's you and I. falls count anywhere.
Oh, damn.
You never know. Maybe I'll claymore the other eye, balance out your black eyes, or maybe I'll say screw it. It's anything goes, which means anything.
Are you serious? My God. You can't. Drew, you can't go around issuing murder threats. Drew McIntyre, stop trying to murder people. Stop threatening murder. You can't kill people. Drew, we have been over this. We have been over it time and time again, Drew McIntyre. You can't kill people. You can't kill people, Drew. You're not allowed. You can't just go with a sword and say, I'm going to chop your head. I'm going to threaten the kid. You can't do that, Drew. It's not allowed. God. You certainly can't do it in Saudi Arabia. Dude, you don't want to go to one of those prisons over there. Come on! I don't know what to say, Drew. You can't murder people. No murdering allowed. Wow. Who thought that I was that passionate about people getting murdered? Apparently very passionate. Drew McIntyre, stop treating people for murder. Why does Vince let Drew have a sword to begin with? It's a good question, man. Like, if you really think about this, right? Really, truly break it down and think about it. WWE is supposed to be more kid-friendly than some other professional wrestling out there. That's just kind of what they market towards. They don't like the mega hardcore stuff. But then this is where WWE loses a good chunk of their audience because they don't know who they're necessarily tailoring towards. They're trying to reach like this big, wide audience that also is kid-friendly. And then you run into situations where he's like, ah, Drew McIntyre, we need something to be with Drew McIntyre. You know what we're going to put on Drew McIntyre so that we can sell action figures and we can sell all of that? A sword. Let's put a sword with him, and that way people will buy his figure and they will like to play with the sword and all that. Makes sense on paper. But then you see it on TV and you see a man threatening to literally just slice your damn head off or stab you with a sword. With a freaking weapon, legitimate life-ending weapon. It's been used for years and years and years throughout the human history to murder people. And he just is threatening people, left, right, and center. It's just like that. If you're that kid watching right there, how is that kid friendly? If that's what you're going for. So no more murder. Steve Taylor says, I'm wondering why they haven't had the segment yet of Drew stabbing someone behind a crate. TikTok, WWE, good lord. Macho Studio says, I have a sword. Awesome! Don't threaten to murder people with it. Because of GTA, that's taken over con. The sword isn't even real. Pish posh. Pish posh. Pish posh. That sword's real. Maybe not sharp. It's real, though. Khan complains when Drew points a sword at Madcap, but if the sword was pointed at JD, Khan wouldn't give a rat's ass. Come on, man. I'm not wishing death on anybody. Not at all. Not at all. Dude Duff says, I have a toy lightsaber, and there's a way for murder. Oh, well, don't need to find it. Big Tiger says, Veer is coming to SmackDown. Is he? I must have missed that. Khan, we've seen people try to kill each other before in wrestling. Chill. Also, it's presented as TV-14, I believe. Is it presented as TV-14 now? I think it's presented as PG. I might be wrong, though. But yeah, Nicholas Smalley, this is all just a running gag. I don't actually freaking care. Just Drew McIntyre. He's a character. He's not actually going to kill people. But I'm just saying, in terms of making stories feel a little more realistic, not threatening murder is an easy way to do it.
Charlotte Flair making her intentions known, but she's got to do it all on her own because by order of the chair...
That's right, we got Naomi versus Charlotte Flair tonight.
Naomi challenges Charlotte Flair for the SmackDown Women's Championship tonight. And a week from Saturday,
you guys getting excited for the Elimination Chamber? Yes or no in this chat. If it was MMA, it would be different. Would it? Do I think Goldberg ends the show? Yeah, I do. I do. Oh, never mind. Here's Goldberg right now. Michael Cole and Goldberg.
Don't take this personally. I love you like a brother.
You know, very few people have accomplished what you have in this industry. Bill, you and I have known each other for many years. But there are whispers out there. A lot of people are talking that this may be one comeback too many.
See, and that's the problem. The problem over the past number of years is I've listened to a couple of those people. And it's taken me out of my game.
That's me. I called him Goldberg. Blame me.
The page.
Blame me, I've distracted Bill.
Damn what anybody thinks.
Big Daddy Bill got distracted because of Khan.
Not Roman Reigns. No one. So as far as comebacks are concerned, this one's going to stick. And this one is going to be everlasting. And this one will call upon the old Goldberg you remember.
You know, this match was supposed to take place 2 years ago at WrestleMania and didn't. And Roman Reigns said earlier tonight, this is much different than it was 2 years ago.
Might be different for Roman Reigns. He may call himself the tribal chief, the head of the table, whatever moniker he wants to use with his entourage going in the ring. But for me, it ain't changed. I'm still the same Goldberg. And he's going to get what he deserves because it's been taken. Yeah, it's... 2 years coming, 10 years coming, 15 years coming. It's finally gonna happen.
You know, Roman Reigns said that, A, he will make you acknowledge him next Saturday at Elimination Chamber, and B, he will Goldberg Goldberg.
Yep.
Firstly, he must have an extremely short memory because I acknowledged Roman Reigns last week as my next victim. What's about to happen at Elimination Chamber, after I destroy him, is he will acknowledge me as the new Universal Champion. I will take the title, and I will walk into the main event at WrestleMania, and I will...
I think Goldberg's reading.
Lesnar, and his ass will be next. As far as Goldberging Goldberg, good luck with that, kid.
I think Goldberg's reading off a script. I'm pretty damn certain he was just reading his entire promo right there. God, this is a dull episode. Very dull. Very, very dull. All right. So we've got about another half hour left in this show, 35 minutes. What would you guys rate the show so far? I think I've got to get this out of 5.5 right now. This is just passable, man. Just passable. What would my Mania card be like? That's an answer for another time when I've been able to sit down and think about it. This hasn't been great, says Ross. Yeah, 5.5, 5.5, 5, 5, 7 out of 10. Yeah, unfortunately, guys, one of those nights, isn't it? We do have a women's championship match between Charlotte and Naomi coming up. So that's at least something. Anything else announced? No, nothing else announced. So that's that. From the Philippines here, Khan, says HSA. Well, welcome to the stream, my friend. It's good to have you. Hey, looks like we're jumping right into this women's match. Amazing. Bring it to the floor. Cringe dance coming. All right, there we go. Freaking cringe dance is over. Naomi, coming on down. It's going to be our main event next, I think. Naomi, Charlotte. Women's title on the line. All right. What do we have on Rampage here tonight? Let's take a look at Rampage. Because this is... I'm ready for Rampage. I'm ready for the Reddit at this rate. God, can you guys believe that? I'm ready for the Reddit over this SmackDown. It might not even be a 5.5. This might be lower. Let's see how this main event goes. Okay, so... Rampage. AEW tonight. Let's see. Preview. So we've got ourselves Bryan Danielson speaking. So probably going to mention something with him and Moxley. That's cool. We have the Young Bucks versus Roppongi Vice. We have Britt Baker versus Robin Renegade in a non-title match. We have Hook versus Blake Lee. So Hook is going to be in action. That's awesome. And then we have the tag titles on the line. Jurassic Express versus the Gun Club. Couple of ass boys in that ring. So, yeah, that's going to be a decent episode of Rampage, isn't it? It's decent. Excited to see what Danielson has to say, actually. And then Young Bucks versus Roppongi Vice will probably be really solid. Britt Baker, Robin Renegade. Don't know much about Robin Renegade. And then Hook is always entertaining to watch. So that's going to be a solid hour. But once again, my friends, if you're enjoying the show, please consider leaving a like. If you're really enjoying the show, you can always consider dropping a super chat donation. Any little bit is appreciated, as it is you guys who keep this channel rolling week in and week out. Without your guys' support, this channel ceases to exist. So thank you. Also, consider becoming a member if you'd like to support that way. We have not really taken a look at Twitter this evening, so maybe we'll go on over there. Cue cards on the floor, maybe. Yeah, maybe something like that. Con man dancing, yeah. People are saying on Discord that Aliyah won't be champion, but I want Aliyah as champion. Hey, dude. If you want Aliyah as champion, be loud for her. Support her. That's how they eventually become champions. We have Bud Jack saying, I think Sonya is going to send someone to distract slash attack Naomi and cost her the match. I'm calling it. Maybe Shayna Baszler. Maybe Shayna gets sent out as Sonya Deville's little henchman, I guess. They said that Pat McAfee is not on SmackDown tonight because he is at the Super Bowl, yet next week's show is also filmed tonight. Oh, next week's show is filmed tonight. I didn't know that. That makes sense because they're traveling. I wonder what excuse they use for Pat not being on commentary next week as well. Interesting. Con man, imagine it's the main event of WWE Chamber. Goldberg is making his entrance, but the Usos jump him, and he can no longer compete, only for a man in yellow to run him off. It's Veer! He walks down, takes Bill's place, hits a clothesline finisher, 1, 2, 3, and new. Some super, super booking right there. I'm going to give you a nice little favorite. Apparently I'm in a beard as well from Jeffrey Rudolph. Christian says, who will win the Super Bowl this Sunday? I don't know, man. I'm going to enjoy it, though. Going to enjoy it. I actually have to go out tomorrow, and I got to get a pork shoulder because I'm making some pulled pork for the Super Bowl. Charles Wright, the man who's always right. He says, hey, con man, I'm ready for my wrestling universe stuff next Sunday. It will be Fastlane. Can't wait. You have an IC title match, and you are paired with the botch guy in the universe. That's awesome, man. That's awesome. Hopefully your universe goes well. I really want to see you grow a thick beard. Is Keith Lee going to be on Rampage tonight, says Serious Gaming. I don't believe so. I don't believe so. I do think there will be some... I think Jay White will come out to the ring with the Young Bucks and Adam Cole. That's what I think's going down. So I think we will see Jay White on Rampage. Not Keith Lee, though. I hope Miro shows up on AEW since he needs a storyline. Apparently, Miro has been out either injured or he hasn't been healthy. One of the two. And he is now just waiting on creative, so... He should be back anytime. It's time for Naomi versus Charlotte Flair, though. Let's get some woos in the chat for Charlotte. Woo! Here comes the queen. And remember, my friends, we've got the brand new Keith Lee donation theme song if you want to check that out. Everything that you need to know for our donation theme songs are available in the description below. There's the queen. Woo! Charlotte Flair! So you can get your votes in. Either vote one for Charlotte or vote two for Naomi. Am I the only one shocked there hasn't been any boring chants? There hasn't been any segments long enough for the fans to chant boring. It's not like the matches themselves are boring, they're just uneventful. They're predictable. You can see what's going to happen a mile away. This is a throwaway episode of SmackDown. Other than this match they could... If WWE really wants to turn things upside down heading into Mania season, put the title on Naomi. Do it. Do it. You have some time to take the title off of her before WrestleMania season, and then maybe you just make a big babyface out of it. Maybe. Do it. Have Ronda distract Charlotte Flair a little bit in this match and have Naomi roll her up for the dub. Do it.
From Orlando, Florida, Naomi! And her opponent, she is the SmackDown Women's Champion, Charlotte Flair!
6 times in her career, Charlotte Flair has held the SmackDown gold. She's also been a tag team champion and a winner of the Royal Rumble. On the other side of the ring, Naomi, a former 2-time SmackDown Women's Champion. She won the Women's Battle Royal at WrestleMania a couple of years ago, and tonight she has her sights set on the Women's Championship.
Thank you, Michael Cole. That is a great introduction to this match. Here we go, Women's Championship time. Naomi versus Charlotte Flair. Alright, so Sonya Deville apparently cannot lay a hand on Naomi, otherwise her job will be in serious jeopardy. The women's title is officially on the line here. Naomi with some sweet looking shoes, by the way, but Charlotte Flair just slams her down into the ring. Raises her hands up high. Naomi, though, just kept right up and then puts her hand right in the face of Charlotte, ducks underneath that clothesline. Naomi now up for a hurricanrana. Around she goes. Charlotte Flair taken down. Oh, right. There's rumors that we are going to get Edge versus AJ Styles at Mania. There is Jeff Samuel. I would love to see it. That's a dream match. AJ versus Edge. Yes, please. I think a lot of people would like to see that. Oh, man. Twisting through the air was Naomi and taking out Charlotte Flair on the outside of the ring. Looks like Naomi's winning right now as we go to our first commercial break in this main event. Chris Lemieux says, do I really think Flair would lose with that Rousey match at WrestleMania coming up? Only if Ronda Rousey gets involved in this match and somehow costs Charlotte Flair the title. They could do, man, I don't think they have anything for the SmackDown Women's Championship at Elimination Chamber, but I could be wrong. Let me just double check that. Like, I think they just have Becky versus Lita, right? They don't have a women's title. They don't have the SmackDown women's title on the line. No, they don't. Yeah, here's what I would say. This would have been an easy way to book it. You could have had a women's elimination chamber for the SmackDown women's title. Tonight on SmackDown, you could have had Naomi taking the title from Charlotte Flair going into Elimination Chamber, and then you could have put the title right back on Charlotte. Like, somehow, some way, she wins the chamber, and then you have her ready for Ronda Rousey. The heat on Charlotte would be there. It might make people want to cheer Ronda Rousey if Charlotte got that win inside the chamber, and especially taking the title right back after she just lost it. That's probably how I would have booked it, but I get that it's a pay-per-view and you can't necessarily have everything the way you want it to. Ronnie says, possibility. Naomi will win, then Sonya comes out and does a rematch, then Charlotte wins it back. But I wouldn't want that because it's just another title to add to Charlotte Flair. You know what, man? You might be onto something. They might be doing that here tonight. You never know. I used to say that AJ should be the one to retire Triple H, but it makes more sense for Randy Orton to do that. Interesting. I've said HBK versus Flair was one of the best men's matches, if not the best, but what about women's matches? What is the greatest women's match of all time? Greatest women's match of all time. I don't know if this is... if this is right off the top of my head, if I'm going to forget a few. Ones that jump out to me, I remember Charlotte Flair versus Sasha Banks on an episode of Raw where Sasha won the Raw Women's Championship and she made Charlotte Flair tap out over like the handrail, right? She locked in the bank statement over the handrail. That's one of them. Bayley versus Sasha Banks at NXT TakeOver Brooklyn. That's got to be one of them. Bianca Belair versus Sasha Banks at this past WrestleMania. That was really good. A really underrated one that people don't talk about enough is AJ Lee versus Caitlyn. That one, I can't remember what pay-per-view, but that was a bona fide awesome match. I think Charlotte Flair and Rhea Ripley put on a pretty good match a couple years ago. What else off the top of my head? Mickey versus Lita on Raw main event. That's a pretty famous one. Thinking back to NXT, there was some really solid matches with Shayna Baszler. I'm just trying to remember if Rhea Ripley, Shayna Baszler. It's probably not in the conversation of greatest of all time. It was a really solid one, though. Crossbody there from Naomi onto Charlotte Flair. Into the cover, count of two, and a kick out. What do you guys think is the greatest women's match of all time? It's really difficult to say, but there's been a lot of great ones. And to think the amount of great matches we've seen just in the last few years compared to, no offense, but all the years before. There's also another women's match that I remember. I think it was Asuka versus the Iconics and versus Nikki Cross down in NXT. It was a fatal four-way match. That one was a banger of a match. It was really good. Ember Moon versus Asuka. Yeah, that was good. It was really good. The triple threat match. Yeah, Charlotte, Becky, Sasha at WrestleMania. That one was really good for the women's title. It was really solid. Becky versus Sasha, Hell in a Cell match. Another seriously solid, solid match. Guys, I don't think people appreciate the generation that we're witnessing right now of women's wrestling. Like, I know people say it's the greatest women's wrestling of all time, but, like, people truly are not appreciating this for how damn good this has been for a while. Women's wrestling has been the best part of WWE. Maybe not the biggest part, but the most consistently best part of WWE for a few years now. Probably going on 4 years. Oh, big shot right there. Naomi takes down Charlotte Flair. Jackknife cover. Two. Charlotte bridges right back up, though. Looking for a backslide. Naomi lands on her feet, though. Beautiful. And there's a chop to Naomi. Oh, man. Naomi getting chopped real hard. There's three chops right to the chest. Four chops. Reverses that. Ducks underneath, though. Up and around. Goes for another hurricanrana, but runs into a backbreaker. In the cover. Two. Kick out by Naomi. Remember, though, my friends, if you're enjoying this video, make sure you leave a like on it. It would be great if we could hit 200 likes. That is 7 more likes. And also, my friends, if you would like to, it would be very kind if you consider dropping a Super Chat donation. That's how these streams continue to run every single week. So thank you, my friends. It's been a very entertaining era. Not all the women involved are as big as others, but they hold their own. We'll look back at this era of women's wrestling and be like, my goodness, it is, I don't know if you will ever get another four horsewoman coming up through the WWE and just legitimately changing the game. Like, it's great to see that women's wrestling. This is the main event on SmackDown, guys. Look what we're watching right now. This is a main event on SmackDown. You go back 4 years ago, this is unheard of. Which is insane to say. The amount of growth that WWE has done for their women's division over the last few years is truly mind-boggling. And it's great to see, and it's long overdue. Wait, nice neckbreaker there from Naomi. Kick out by Flair. Big kick out by Charlotte Flair. New force woman might be Raquel, Dakota Kai, Kaylee Ray, and Miko. I'm sorry, my friend. I don't see that. If you're right about it, then I will gladly admit that I'm wrong, but I just don't see that happening. Miko Santamora is just a little further up there in age. I don't see her being ever a person on the main roster unless they just do one-off matches. But it's not like WWE likes to do one-off matches. They don't bring in people just for the sake of, like, a pop or sake of like a one-off match. Think of Jericho and the all the people that they've brought in against Jericho. You know, in AEW, they like to do those one-off matches where they bring in people from outside of the business. And even though Miko Santamura is in NXT UK, to WWE, that is outside of the business. They, unless it's normal NXT, like NXT 2.0, NXT UK is barely considered to be a part of WWE. Like, they don't look at that as the next step. They look at that as like the step before the next step. Anyways. The Batman. Only beaters March 4th. Has Women of Wrestling had their first show yet? I don't know. I actually don't follow WOW Wrestling. I don't. So I have no idea. Sex Dragon, how you doing? He says, this match started out awkwardly, but it's become a great one. It's become a good one, not a great one. It's good. It's fine. Jamie Todd says, just putting the image of Lord Tensai in lingerie with Brodus Clay in your dead. Sorry, not in your head. Yeah, that was mean. That was really mean. Yeah, what the frig was Vince McMahon on? Tons of funk. What the frig was Vince McMahon on? Like, I gotta find this photo right here. Tons of funk. I don't even know what to Google. I was trying to find when they were in that, like, lingerie stuff, but I can't find it. Sorry, guys. One sec. I just heard my dog bite back up pretty loudly. One sec. I'm just going to check to make sure she's okay.
Plus, see the 2022 Royal Rumble winner Ronda Rousey and the boss Sasha Banks team up against SmackDown Women's Champion Charlotte Flair and the Queen of Spades Shayna Baszler. Be a part of it all and more when the Blue Brand takes over Place Belle on Sunday, March 6th in Montreal. Tickets are on sale right now at Evenco and Ticketmaster. I'm Scott Stanford, and this has been your WWE News Slam.
This program is aggressive in nature. It may contain themes that are not suitable for everyone. Viewer discretion is advised.
Will Charlotte Flair retain, or will Naomi become the new SmackDown Women's Champion? We find out here tonight, live on Friday Night SmackDown on Fox. Charlotte in control, Naomi trying desperately to rally.
No doubt about it, Ronda Rousey watching this match incredibly closely.
Because remember, Ronda Rousey last week decided she wanted to challenge for the SmackDown Women's Championship and Charlotte Flair at WrestleMania. Those plans would change if Naomi wins here tonight. Rousey, of course, winning that right by winning the Women's Royal Rumble.
Right now, Charlotte Flair, the deep rear chin lock on the challenger, Naomi, who the WWE Universe here in New Orleans is trying to will back into this fight.
And Naomi creates some space.
Naomi escapes out the backside.
Lands on her feet. Oh, and there's the cover on Charlotte to win the Women's Championship and a kick out.
Charlotte went to the well once too often, attempted the same tilt-a-whirl backbreaker. Naomi now with the momentum.
Yeah, using the springboard off the second rope to deliver the
that
kick to Charlotte.
That could do it.
Into the cover again for the championship. And a win for Naomi and a kick out by Charlotte at two. Another near fall. Charlotte being taken to the limit here tonight by Naomi.
And this is where we'll find out what Naomi's truly made of. This deep into the matchup, Naomi needs to find a way to keep her foot on the gas pedal, to keep applying pressure to the champion.
The WWE Universe in New Orleans trying to help Naomi somehow pull it out in this match against the opportunity. Charlotte Flair.
Naomi now looking for something big, drives the champion face first, middle turnbuckle.
And that could be it. Naomi looking to head up to the top rope. Is this enough to put Charlotte away? Could this be Naomi's moment? Naomi.
Oh my God. Freaking dog, man. Freaking dog. We really got to get this shit under control here. He just bit Becca really, really hard right underneath the butt cheek and drew a lot of blood. He's only what, 11 weeks, so he's still young, he's still learning, but my God. Yeah, she's okay, she's in tears, but she's okay. So he's in his crate now, and he's in his crate for the rest of the night. Right on the back of the leg, right underneath the butt cheek, just jumped up. She just took him out for a pee and a poop and a play, and they were having a great night together. And just straight up, he just flipped a switch and just attacked her. And it's like, are you kidding? Like, we love this dog, but his biting is starting to get really bad. So we're going to be taking him to some puppy classes pretty soon once he's vaccinated. Sounds so weird saying once he's vaccinated, but puppies need their vaccines in order to be able to go out in public. God damn it, dog. All right, anyways, back to this matchup right now. Charlotte Flair is going all the way to the top rope. Charlotte Flair. Oh, moonsault. Oh, man, Naomi gets her knees up, though. Rear view, into the cover, two. Oh, kick out by Flair. Woo. Wow. Wow, I thought for a second there we might have had a new women's champion. Con, is he spayed or neutered? Not yet, Samuel Vlogs. He is 11 weeks old. He's not old enough to be able to get spayed or neutered. Well, I mean, it's a he, so neutered, but yeah. Have I thought of a muzzle if it gets worse? No, that's a bad idea, dude. It's a terrible idea. Muzzles make dogs more aggressive. Wait, into the cover. Two, kick out there by Naomi. Naomi lands on her feet. Oh my god, Naomi going again. Naomi, there it is. Come on, roll her over. One, two, kick out by Flair. Oh. My lord. What an effort by both of these women. All right, this picked up in the last few minutes here, didn't it? It looks like people here in the chat are saying this is a good match. You guys a fan of this one? I think this is going to keep my rating at 5.5. Oh, man. Nice shot right there from Naomi. Deep into the cover again. Two. Kick out by Flair. Woo. Yeah, David, I think that's the game plan. We're going to take him to some puppy school once he gets his vaccine and he's able to go into them. Man, decent match. The fans are chanting, this is awesome. The fans are into it. No doubt about that. You're right, the crowd has come alive during this match. This is the most alive this crowd has sounded all night. Now going for it, split-legged moonsault! Oh my god! Come on! Two! Kick out by Flair! Oh, come on! Oh! I thought it was over. Holy shit. Wow. But Naomi now, you gotta go in there. Feel the glow, goes to the cover again. Count of two, and Flair just gets her foot on the bottom rope. And kicks out. Remember to make sure you guys leave a like on this video if you are enjoying the stream. Let's get this all the way up to 250 likes for this pretty damn good main event on this evening. Come on, Naomi. Do it. Big boot from Flair misses that one. Forearm to the face from Naomi. She's landed like 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 of those. Maybe 10. Good lord, Naomi. Oh, come on. Flair just snags her by the weave. But then there's a big shot right there to the side of the head. Come on, Naomi, rear view. No, Flair. Oh, what the frig was that? What the frig was that? Oh, there's the chop block followed up by the natural selection. Two. And Flair retains. 5.5 out of 10. That's my rating for the show. Charlotte Flair retains. Damn. Naomi gave it her all. No doubt about it. She gave it everything that she had, but... And Sonya steps into the ring. Hang on. Come on, Sonya, touch her. Seriously, I hope Sonya just touches Naomi by mistake. Naomi now, hang on. Naomi punching Sonya Deville. Just fighting right back against the GM. Good lord. Oh my god, you can't do that. Charlotte from behind. Wait, Sonya! Sonya just stomped away. Oh my god, here comes Ronda Rousey! Ronda's here, and Ronda's gonna make the save! Ronda running on down to that ring. Gets inside the ring right after Sonya Deville just kicks her away. But Sonya Deville did stomp on Naomi. Sonya now. Uh-oh. Sonya saying, my arm's still injured. Uh-oh, Ronda still takes her down. How about a sling for the other arm? Tell me Sonya's going to be in a sling next week with both of her arms. Oh, Charlotte Flair pulls her out of the ring. Damn. All right. So Ronda Rousey saves Naomi. Charlotte and Sonya stand tall at the end of the night. And that's the show. My rating is going to be a 5.5 out of 10. That one was a, other than the main event, that was pretty much a, as bland of a show as you get. I couldn't even tell you what truly happened on it. It's like they made it the go-home show for Saudi Arabia, but didn't actually give us a go-home show. Like, I don't know. That's, to me, that was just kind of a bland episode. So 5.5 out of 10 from moi. That's moi. But it's time for Rampage, everyone. So if you were just here for SmackDown, I want to say thank you very much for watching along this evening. If you're going to be here for Rampage, then we are live for the next hour. And then if you also want to be here for the Reddit, that will be taking place right after Rampage. So everyone, thank you so much for tuning in to Friday Night SmackDown. Once again, my name is Conman167. Make sure you guys leave that like. Jamie Todd says next week is the go-home show. I know it's next week. I said that tonight. Feel like it was a go-home show without it actually being the go-home show. God, man, you need to learn to listen. You love jumping on me, but you don't actually listen. Yes, that does make Ronda babyface again. Yeah, a little bit, doesn't it? What comes after Rampage? After Rampage, we're going to be going to the Reddit. So the Conman167 Reddit, if you guys have not. Okay, come on. Come on, Rampage. There we go. If you have not joined our Reddit, I'm going to post the link right now. And if you guys wanted to post any conversations over there, any funny photos, any whatever, you can. We will be looking at that as a community right after the AEW Rampage live stream, which is taking place here in just a few moments. Once again, everybody, make sure you drop that like if you have not done so, and also making sure you are subscribed to the channel. So let's flop this on over to AEW. And switch this over right here as well. Boom. And then tonight, guys, the streams are not done after the Reddit either. We are going to go live with Lost Ark. And that's going to be over on the Con Games channel. So I'll be sure to post that for you guys in the chat as well. Once again, that is the Con Games channel. We're going live with Lost Ark, a game that literally was released today. So, big game. It is free to play. So make sure you check us out over on Con Games, okay? What time do I plan on going to bed tonight? I honestly don't know. But if you'd like to subscribe to Con Games, which I highly recommend you guys doing, there it is. Link is in the chat. And then we're also going to be live tomorrow with UFC 271. So join us there. But it's time for Rampage. It's Friday. You know what that means. I must say, I love that AEW adopted John Huber's "you know what that means" thing for AEW's tagline. It's a really classy move on their part. All right, here we go. This match is officially underway. Young Bucks versus Roppongi Vice. This match should probably be a banger. So, let's get the poll up here asking you who will win. Who will win? So, Roppongi Vice. Who is Roppongi Vice? Trent and Rocky Romero. So, Roppongi Vice. Or will it be the Young Bucks? Damn, four-time IWGP Tag Team Champions for Roppongi Vice. So if you guys don't know about them, you're going to learn a little bit about these guys. What breed of dog is Tucker? He is an English Springer Spaniel. Oh, nice move there from Trent and Rocky Romero. Now Rocky goes down into the cover, hooks the leg, but broken up there by Nick Jackson. Yeah, do I still play Valheim? I do not. Haven't opened Valheim in a long time. Nice Roppongi Vice. Clotheslines into the corner. Do I think there's a reason why both WWE and AEW have been taking shots at Eddie Guerrero lately? Honestly, man, if you go back through the history of the business and you take a look at anybody who's got any affiliation to Eddie, it's like brought up 9 times out of 10. Like, almost every single storyline that has some sort of affiliation to Eddie is brought up. Any Rey Mysterio storyline, brought up. Dominic Mysterio, brought up with him. Vicky Guerrero, brought up with him. Chavo, certainly brought up with him. It's like literally any. Wait a second. Roppongi Vice going out there after the Young Bucks. The Young Bucks are trying to run away. Oh my god! Double super kick from the Young Bucks, and now they're running back to the ring. Oh, man, are the Young Bucks literally going to win this via countout? Roppongi Vice just got hit with a double super kick, and they're both down. Hamidi asking me how was SmackDown. A little on the boring side, my friend. A little boring. Count of 8. Count of 9. Rocky Romero just got back in time. Woo! That was close. It was very, very close. Roppongi Vice is Trent and Rocky Romero. They've been all over AEW TV for the last while. If you've seen Rocky Romero with the Best Friends, that's the affiliation. Ooh. Double neck breaker. Beautifully done from the Young Bucks. These guys showing why they're still one of the best tag teams in the world. Yeah, flat smack because they don't want Benoit mentioned. But they still with the Best Friends? Yeah, of course, buddy. It's Trent and Rocky Romero. I think you're not aware of their history. Trent and Rocky Romero, they just mentioned on the show as well. Four-time IWGP heavy tag team champions. So they're an established tag team. This is them pulling on their history. Young Bucks and Roppongi Vice. Two teams synonymous with New Japan Pro Wrestling tag team wrestling. Now, oh man, the Young Bucks. Wait a second, where's Orange Cassidy going? Uh-oh, hang on. Orange is going under the ring. And I think it's about to get very evil up in here. Uh-oh. Danhausen. Danhausen's there. Freaking Danhausen. Oh my god, he just cursed the Young Bucks too? No way! Uh-oh! So Roppongi Vice is kind of like Proud and Powerful, a subgroup. No, it's a tag team. It's a tag team between Trent and Rocky Romero. It's a tag team. They just happen to also be in Best Friends, right? It's, oh man, Rocky Romero, nice move. But they are a tag team. They existed before the Best Friends existed. Very elite. Very evil. Yes, yes. Very elite. Very evil. Uh, has anyone ever watched Danhausen's YouTube videos? No, but I plan to, honestly. Hey, Samuel. Welcome to the stream, bud. We're going to send Hook later. Yes, we are. Yes, we are. I'm excited for Hook. You guys excited for Hook? Amity says, yeah, a tag team that are in Best Friends but go by a different name like Proud and Powerful does, although they in the Inner Circle. Yeah, I just wouldn't refer to them as a subgroup. That's just not how I would refer to them. They are a tag team who happens to be in a faction. It's a little bit like the Revival. They're a tag team who happens to be in the Pinnacle as well. And yeah, Proud and Powerful is a tag team who happens to be in the Inner Circle, but maybe not after this past Wednesday. We'll see next week. Good vibes. Where's everyone watching from? Says connecting people through wrestling. They are in Florida. Nice, man. So what are they doing with Chuck? He's still in the Best Friends. Still in the Best Friends. I don't know how to describe this to you, Amity. AEW doesn't work necessarily like WWE's television does. They have a lot of shows that are happening, but they also allow their talents to go and work the indies. Or at least some of their talents to go and work the indies. So they don't always have stuff going on for all their talent. It's like they got a filter which comes in and comes out. Some people are away for a few weeks on TV and then they pick up their stories later on. But one thing I've noticed from AEW TV is that they seem to at least, for the most part, follow up on the stories that they do post on TV. Whether it be a month from now, whether it be 2 months from now, or whether it be next week, they generally follow up on their stories. Yes, there's been a few stories that have just been dropped out of the blue, but not all of them. Most of them, they get picked up again at some point. Like, you can talk about Kyle O'Reilly and Bobby Fish with Red Dragon. They've all of a sudden just been off TV, and Adam Cole is having something with Jay White and the Young Bucks now. So it's like, where the heck did they go? But they will come back eventually, and they will end up in that feud against the Young Bucks, and whose side is Adam Cole on, and all that stuff. The CMU draw is on Tuesday. Yeah, I think so, right? The 15th? Yeah, if we are live on Tuesday, we might do it on Monday, just because it's a bigger stream. I'll let you guys know. Rampage is on next Friday at a different time, 7 East, 6 Central. So it's on a little earlier next week, guys. So that's good to know. Rampage next Friday on at 7 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Then we'll go live with SmackDown after that. Oh, man, nice knee right there. Roppongi Vice putting down the Young Bucks. Monday is Valentine's Day, Con. Shit, yeah, it is. Wow, yeah, it is. I'm going to have to figure out something. Man, that snuck up on me. Holy shit, how is it already halfway through February? Like, on Monday, how? When is UFC 271? Tomorrow! Tomorrow is UFC 271. We'll be live, I think, around 7 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. That's what I think. Hey, 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 we just got the biggest donation of the day. It's Dante151 dropping $10. Thank you, Dante. He says, hey, con man, a dream match that I could see happening is Keith Lee versus Wardlow for a chance to face either Adam Cole or Adam Page for the AEW World Championship. Damn. You might be booking it a little too soon, Dante, but yes to that match. Keith Lee versus Wardlow is a match I'd like to see. Uh-oh. Double German suplex from Roppongi Vice. Oh. Ghostface asking me, what am I going to do to treat Becca? I literally just said 5 seconds ago that I have no idea what I'm doing. It snuck up on me yet. We've spent a lot of money very recently. Like, a lot of money. So much so that I don't really have much left to be able to spend. So I'll have to figure out something. Probably some flowers and chocolate. Something simple. I bought her a dog, for goodness sakes. On your knees, dog. All hail.
Bow down to the
king.
Hey, con man, a dream match that I could see happening is Keith Lee versus Wardlow for a chance to face either Adam Cole or Adam Page for the AEW World Championship title.
Uh-oh. All the Young Bucks were going for it, too. Oh, my God. Roppongi Vice almost beat the Young Bucks right there. That was close. Yo, I'd like to see Trent and Rocky Romero get the dub here. There it is. Oh, man. 450 splash. Matt Jackson now caught by Trent. Trent! Oh, my God. What a throw. Trent! The strong zero delivered. Oh, my God. Nick Jackson just breaks it up. Just. And remember, if you guys wanted to see or hear the new Keith Lee donation theme song that we have, it's available. There are so many badass moves. I just wish they mattered. Fair. Roppongi. Oh, my God. Oh, what? Matt Jackson lands on his feet from a doomsday device. What a move. Caught. Meltzer driver. 1, 2. Oh, what? Trent broke it up now. What a match. Damn. Double super kick to Trent. That might have kicked a tooth out. Oh, man. BTE. Trigger. Boom. Rocky is down. 1, 2, 3. The Young Bucks get the dub. That was really good. That was really good. The BTE trigger. Let's get some E's in the chat for the Elite. Hang on. Cutler getting right in the face of Orange Cassidy. Filming that vlog for the Young Bucks. Uh-oh. Just sprayed the cold spray right at Orange Cassidy. And then Orange Cassidy now kicking him in the legs. Oh, orange punch to Cutler. Double super kick to Cassidy. And they get out of there. Oh, boy. Uh-oh! Switchblade's there! Jay White! The Blade Runner has been delivered to Trent. Switchblade is here. Wait a second. Doesn't that have some New Japan implications as well? Chaos, right? Yeah. That should send some message to Chaos. Huh. The Blade Runner from the Switchblade. Wow. This wrestling world is intense. There's so much going on right now. I love it. Jay White, not Jay Lethal. I'm never going to live that one down, am I? God, I'm never going to be able to live that down. I'm the guy who called Jay White Jay Lethal. Like, I'm that dude. I was that guy. Ryan Vizquez says, I am leaving. Enjoy Rampage. I'll see you next time. See you later, my friend. Thanks for stopping by. Looked like a Sister Abigail. Same type of move. Yeah. Wait, Jay Lethal is with Chaos or is he with the Bullet Club? He's Bullet Club, baby. No, I will not, says Jeff. Oh, God, it's a switchblade. Jay Lethal. Good Lord. Yeah, yeah. Running memes. Running jokes. You guys are hilarious. Honestly, the Usos versus Young Bucks would be a great match. Hell yeah, it would. Hell yeah. Dante says, I want a new Bullet Club versus Elite match. We might get it. Yo, this forbidden door might be open. Things might be happening in this world of wrestling sooner rather than later. A lot of good, interesting stuff happening. Oh my God, they're literally doing dog DNA stuff. Like the family trees, but for dogs. Are you fucking kidding me? I have a dog, and not even I would buy that. Good Lord. How much money do people literally drop on their pets? Who would do that? Literally, who would do that? If you do that, I want to know what your thought process was, because that... It's like ancestry DNA or whatever it is, or like the freaking, you send them like a bit of your spit or something in a vial and they tell you everything about you. Yeah. Yeah. Imagine doing that as well. Imagine just giving away your information freely like that. Imagine just giving away your DNA like that. Just imagine you're doing that. Those people who do those things, they don't realize what they're selling. They don't realize what they're giving away. You're literally giving away your DNA to just some random ass company. And you think they're gonna protect your information? Hell no. No way. Not a chance. Not a chance. They'll sell your information quicker than they sell you your product. 23andMe. That's what it's called. That's right. Yeah. Yeah. Don't use those guys. Don't do them. Don't touch them with a 10-foot pole. Stay away. Hey, Jen Carter, how you doing? Young boy Trey says, the Forbidden Door has been open since 2016 because of Samoa Joe, Shinsuke Nakamura, and AJ Styles. Incredibly false, my friend. Those guys were free agents, their contract had expired, and they came on over to WWE. They signed them. That makes them WWE contracted people back in that time. They were not walking through the Forbidden Door. Walking through the Forbidden Door means you're signed to another major promotion. And you show up on another major promotions television show is essentially what it is. Powerhouse Hobbs is a star in the making. I would draft that guy on my brand, and he's a guy that you build for the future. So Dante Martin versus Powerhouse Hobbs. Okay, next Friday, special start time of 7 Eastern. Cool. Qualifying match for the Face of the Revolution ladder match. Cool. So we'll hear from Brian Danielson up next. Kenny Salerno says, I've never seen a more underrated wrestler than Hook. Wow. Oh, overrated. That's an even bigger wow. Let me repeat that again. Kenny says, I have never seen a more overrated wrestler than Hook. You haven't been watching wrestling that long then, have you? There's been some pretty overrated wrestlers. I think Hook is great. And you can't deny that he's got the crowd in the palm of his hands.
Excuse me, guys. Sorry to interrupt your wonderful by what you said, that Lee Moriarty should abandon my mentorship.
Wait. Hey, I hope that you're not misinterpreting me. I have an infinite amount of respect for you, Matt. Dude, you're a tremendous wrestler, excellent talent, I'm sure an excellent coach. But what Lee means, you can't teach him.
Wow.
He needs to learn violence.
Hey, hold on. I don't need y'all standing around talking about me like I'm not right here.
Whoa.
You want to see violence? I can show you violence.
Yo, are we going to get Brian versus Lee? All right. Danielson versus Lee on Wednesday. Let's go. But the doctor is in DMD. JoJo Plays asking me, what is my reaction to WWE 2K22 with the 100 character slots? Yeah. Kind of sucks. So if people have not heard, WWE 2K22 is not going to have more than 100 character slots. It looks like it's still going to be the 100 character cap limit, which means our CMU is going to be capped at 100 characters. Nothing I can do about it. Literally nothing I can do about it. I do believe at the start of the CMU for 2K22, we are probably going to remove a few people, but we're going to continue to try to bring more people into the show every single time that we remove people. But yeah, I know. I wanted 150 characters as well there, Jeff. I thought that that was the way to go, but nothing I can do about it. No Jamie Hayter here at ringside either. Lots of people asking where she's at. I actually don't know. All right, so let's get this match up on the screen. Who will win, either Britt Baker or her opponent tonight? What is her opponent's name again? It is... I don't know. Robin something. So who will win? Robin something. All right, we're just going to call her Robin something. Or it's going to be Britt Baker. So get your guys' votes in right here. Either vote one for Robin something. And no, she's not the cousin of Jake something. She's not cousin Jake's cousin. Nope, not that. Or vote two for Britt Baker. Robin Renegade. Ah, that's it. Well, too late. That's up on the screen. It's Robin something now. I didn't even spell the right Robin. It's with a Y, not an I. Oh, well. Am I going to create the CMU arena? Absolutely. Absolutely. How many people are on the CMU roster now, Con? 100. Robin Renegade sent right off the ropes there. Britt Baker catches her into a DDT position. She reverses that. Nice move. Robin Renegade throws her back into the corner. Setting it up. Oh, double knees, but no one home. And Britt Baker just slams her down. Damn. And we continue on in picture and picture. But I hope each and every single one of you are enjoying the show tonight. We've got lots of content still to come, even though it is 10:26. I know people might be thinking, oh, we only have about a half hour left in the show this evening. Man, my night is about to be wrapped up, and I don't know what I'm going to do for the rest of my night. Well, let me tell you what you're going to do for the rest of your night, if you want to. I mean, it's your choice, obviously. But what you can do is you can stay here on this channel right after the Rampage stream is done, because we will then be checking out the Reddit, the Con Man Reddit. There is going to be some cringe videos posted over there. I'm sure there's going to be some funny things to look at. So we will be live looking at the Reddit right after Rampage. And then, once we are done streaming the Reddit, we are going to head on over to Con Games, and we are going to be streaming a brand new game that just launched today. Are you ready for it? Lost Ark is the name of the game. So make sure you guys check us out over there. I'm going to try to find a link. Con Games 167. Boom. We should have my Lost Ark right there. How many people do I have waiting? Anybody? No, nobody's waiting. They're probably all in here. But if you guys want to set your reminder right there, there it is. There's the YouTube link. Con, since I updated the $15 dono, when am I going to update the other donos? When I have time. When I have time. Con, warning before you watch my video tonight. Lots of trailers for March. Oh, great. Trailers, yay. Better be under 6 minutes. I'd love your CMU character was known as the Mule, and rather than Samuel Vlogs, just a rock type character. AEW picture in picture Britt Baker. Yeah, it's a Rampage match. Rampage next week starts at 7. Yes, that's correct, my friends. That is correct. Is it fine that fits 6 minutes and 59 seconds? Fuck me, guys! Ah, like, what? Like, why? I've asked. There's rules literally there. It says keep it under 7 minutes, but I've asked for 6 minutes, and you freaking did 6 minutes and 59 seconds! Like, keep it under 6! It's not that hard! Leave one trailer out! Like, freaking Macho Studios there threw in ads, for God's sakes, to try to make it over 6 minutes. Like, who? Why? I'm gonna freak! God, I said one time I would give you the benefit of the doubt, and I would be like, alright, let's watch it. But no, you're like, oh, well, I'm going to take that one time and I am going to stretch it out and I'm going to make it twice. And then I'm going to say, well, then I just made mine. Like, you know, another, is it fine if it's under 7 minutes this one time? And it's like, yeah, it's fine this one time. Not these 5 other times after. Good Lord. It's all good. It's all out of love, though, guys. But we might have to start changing it to 5 minutes if you guys are going to try to stretch it out one extra minute. Every time that this happens, I take 15 seconds off the amount of time you're allowed to post. How about that? Oh, man. Frog splash there by the Renegade into the cover to kick out by Britt. Yo, Robin Renegade is giving the champion quite a fight right now. Uh-oh. Britt Baker, though, somehow rolls her right back down into the mat. And there's a super kick to the face. Another super kick to the face. Who is Britt Baker facing? Robin Renegade is her name. Renegade. Con, I'ma head out. I'ma go watch my Bay Dakota Kai on Twitch and chat. I'll see you later. Have yourself a wonderful night, buddy. Have yourself a wonderful night. Just out of curiosity, how many of you guys are going to be joining me for Lost Ark over on Con Games? Say me, if you will. Oh, there's the curb stomp to Robin. Britt Baker just wrecked her. Into the cover. 2. It's over. Britt wins. Not as many me's as I thought I would be seeing in the chat. But hey, you know what, guys? I'm glad to have you there. So make sure you join us. I don't know how long we'll be live for. Probably about an hour or two. But yeah. Uh-oh. Oh, no. The girl's got blood coming out of her mouth. Uh-oh. Lockjaw's in. The girl already has blood coming out of her mouth. And Britt Baker just wrenches on it again. But hang on. Here comes Thunder Rosa. Thunder Rosa. Hey, takes out Rebel. That's what we got to do. Thunder double leg takedown going right after Britt Baker. And now the brawl is on. Thunder Rosa not letting up. Lefts and rights delivered by her. Nice to see, man. Wait a second. Oh, Jamie Hayter. Here's Hayter. Jamie Hayter from behind. Oh, man. Jamie plants her down. Mercedes Martinez in the ring as well. Now just shoves her off. Whoa. I'm not sure Jamie Hayter's a fan of Mercedes Martinez for doing that. And now these two are having a stare down. And Britt Baker separating them. Britt says, whoa. Puts her arms around both of them. Gives them both a kiss on their forehead. Chills them out. All right. Oh. Right, Layla Hirsch has turned heel, hasn't she? Whoa, what the fuck? Chris? Oh my god, Chris, what did you just say? Chris Statlander literally just said something along the lines of, if this is how you were as a kid, I don't blame your parents for giving you up. What the fuck? That's a disgusting thing to say for a babyface. That's actually fucked up. That's actually so messed up. That does not make me want to root for Chris Statlander. That's a heel thing to say. But anyways, it's time for Hook. Hook, 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 Hook. Hookamania runs wild. Oh, wow. That was such a messed up comment from Chris Statlander. That was so messed up. But my friends, if you are interested in supporting the channel directly, you can consider dropping a like on this video, becoming a member, or by hitting that super chat donation. Any little bit is appreciated. And Hook is going up against Blake Lee. Handpicked by QT Marshall to face Hook. Jamie Todd says, Hook is that generic wrestler in a universe mode you try to put over and hand all the titles to for fun. I understand that people maybe don't see what everyone sees in Hook, but like, let's remember the most important part of wrestling. Connecting with the fans. Right? Legitimately connecting with the fans. Listen to the shows and understand that when fans react the way they have for Hook, there's something there. You might not like the initial presentation, but there is so much there. The fans are interested in him, and he's had four matches. They are really interested, and they are booking him well. He has the pedigree of the legendary Taz, so that instantly gets him over with the fans. Like, honestly, I don't know where the hate for Hook comes from some people, other than people who are maybe, I don't know, jealous that it's not in the promotion they want him to be in? I don't know. Like, people say he's vanilla, but watch him wrestle. Watch him work. Look at the man. He's not vanilla. He's about as entertaining as you can get for somebody who just burst onto the scene. The only thing that he's lacking is the size. Seriously, that is the only thing right now he's lacking. Maybe he doesn't have the mic skills, but his character doesn't need it right now. Like, look at how great this man is right now in this ring. Look at this arm bar that he's got. QT Marshall, though, getting up on the ring apron. And that's going to distract Hook. Dude, this is where you need to be a little more seasoned. Not let Marshall get advantage. Oh. Oh, Hook just moved out of the way. That's the Samoa Joe move. All right, guys. Vote 2, vote 1. Who do you think is going to win? Hook now. Boom. Exploder. T-bone. Whatever you call it. This is the 5th match from Hook. Hook now forearms across the face. Hook again, another shot across the side of the head. There it is, red drum. Red drum's in. Red drum's in, and it's over. Hook makes him tap out. Another big victory for Hook. Hookamania continues. And he just leaves almost as quickly as he arrived. Wow. God, we I'm just looking over here at the Reddit. Did I make the rules? No videos longer than 7 minutes. I did. I even put that. So when I actually asked, I asked so nicely. I even put my nice face on. I put my big smile on. I was like, please, no more videos over than 6 minutes. And then as I'm scrolling through here, there's a freaking 6 minute and 26 second video, a 7 minute and 29 second video, and a 6 minute and 59 second video. I am instantly changing the rules to no videos over 6 minutes because goddamn, guys, you can't listen. You can't listen to simple rules. So you'll lose the ability. Not one single person kept it under 6, so I'm changing the rules, making sure you don't put it over 6 minutes. Rules, there we go. No videos longer than 6 minutes. Boom. Done. It is official. You guys are evil with the video length. Seriously, they're so evil. Really, Khan, it's only a minute over, I mean. But Noah Saltzman, my friend. Noah Saltzman, it's the principal. It's been a minute over every single video that they have put out. Con, 2K has a character. Or, my bad. 2K has announced that Dominic is an unlockable character. Do I think they will have a Rey storyline where we will get the ladder match with Eddie and Rey? And if we win, we unlock Dominic. I don't know how 2K22 is going to work out. It would be a cool way to unlock Dominic as a character. That would. Big Tiger says, so no Reddit tonight. No, that's not what I'm saying. That's not what I'm saying at all. We're doing the Reddit tonight. I've announced that we're doing the Reddit tonight. Like, many times throughout the stream. Yeah, we're still doing Reddit. Don't show a video over 6 minutes. That will get the point across real quick. Well, that's what we're doing moving forward. I will not be showing videos over 6 minutes. Hook reminds me of a young Clay Guida. All right. All right. For me, WWE feels like a job to watch, while AEW is fun. I don't know why. Dude, I feel that sometimes WWE can be a chore. It can. Macho Studios says, Khan, why? Because I've told you enough fucking times. I've told you enough times that you, like, and you continue not to listen. You're the one who posted a 7 minute and 20 second video. I can't trust you. So that's why. I'll show the 6 minute plus videos today, but not after today. Not after today. What's so special? Usually you don't have night to stream games unless you're on your own. What's so special about tonight? Nothing's so special about tonight. I just haven't been able to stream games during the day because this puppy has been taking over my life. Becca's home, and so I have asked her to do us, this channel, a favor and to look after the doggo, put him to bed tonight, and let me stream, let me work, because for the last month, I have been taking pretty much the dog every single day, been missing a lot of work, and I needed to catch up on some work, so that's what we're doing. I'm currently on track to probably not make enough money for rent this month, if I'm being honest. Just that's the way that it's been going so far with the amount of missed streams that I've had. So I've got to pick up some streams somewhere. Hey, thank you, Samuel. Appreciate that. Macho says, get a part-time job. Fuck me, man. Yes, if I have to. If I absolutely have to, that's the next step. If I have to, but that's not what I have to do. It's because I've missed a lot of streams this month. This is my full-time job. Plus, I love doing it. And the fact that I get to be able to stream with all you guys as often as I do is because I don't work another job, you know? That's how I'm able to do this all the time. Let me tell you something. If I was working another job throughout the day and I was coming home and I was sitting down and trying to record YouTube videos, I would not be live every single day. Just straight up, I'd probably be live with Raw and probably be live with SmackDown and probably be live with the pay-per-views, and that's it. That's what it would be. But because I have the ability to stream as often as I do, because I have the ability to put the time and effort and have the brain power to be able to stream for as often as I do, it's because it's my full-time job, right? And that's just how it is. I love that this is my job. See Wrestling asking, by the way, see, how you doing, buddy? He says, are you streaming UFC tomorrow? Yes, sir. Oh, hell yeah, I am. Yep. It's time for the Ass Boys. Austin Gunn is definitely the more charismatic of the duo. Colton Gunn, not necessarily really all that impressive. But let me just say, Austin Gunn? Yep. Hey, but it's time for that main event. Do I plan to stream games on a night as you look after the dog during the day? Nope, the plan is to be able to stream during the day still. He's just a young puppy, right? Like, you got to remember, guys, this is not my life forever, right? We've got a young puppy. He's 11 weeks old. It's not my life forever. He'll grow up. He'll become a dog. He'll be able to sit right here beside me while I'm streaming. Like, that's just going to be how it is. But right now, we're just teaching him. We're raising essentially a freaking child, man. It's a baby, seriously, in many ways. And anybody who has not had a dog is probably going to laugh at that statement. But anybody who has raised a puppy will know just the amount of training that it takes. And I didn't realize it was going to be this much training when we got him. But I love him. But it would be fun to be able to stream games at night a little more often as well. It depends on how they are received. I don't want to take away too many nights. Because also, you know, it's not fair to Becca. One of the things I was trying to improve this year was my work home life. I felt like I needed to find a way to be there a little bit more for things. And so I'm just okay with when I need to dropping a stream if I need to be there for something and hopefully be able to hit all the big ones. I'm incredibly dedicated to streaming WWE and AEW and moving forward. I'm incredibly, incredibly dedicated, but I also need to make sure I look after my loved one. So who will win? It's either going to be the Gun Club, or it's going to be Jurassic Express. All right, guys, get your votes in. Either vote one or vote two right here in the chat. Vote one for Gun Club. Vote two for Jurassic Express. And man, Billy Gunn, the badass, getting up there on the side of the ring. But yeah, once again, everyone, we have the Reddit taking place right after Rampage here tonight. And then we are going to be heading live over on Con Games with some Lost Ark. Going to be good. Uh-oh, Jungle Boy went to do a deep arm drag. Oh, Jungle Boy, though, with a big clothesline, puts down one half of the Gun Club. Billy Ass and the Ass Boys. Couple of ass boys out there, yes, sir. Uh-oh. The ass boys are about to meet a prehistoric monster. Here he comes. It's the Luchasaurus. Ooh-hoo-hoo-hoo. Man, another big shot there. And then right back into the corner. Jeff says, as someone who has had an 8-year-old and had dogs in the past, the first few years are pretty tough, but eventually they'll go off and do their own thing long enough to get some work done. Yeah, and I mean, I'm not afraid to close my door once, you know, like once I need to, but it's just right now he can't be trusted to be alone, right? So he's either got to be in his play crate, in his regular crate, or being watched right now. He actually, literally yesterday, guys, it was the, oh my God, I can't believe I didn't share this story yet. So I was looking after him, right? And he had kind of got quiet for about 2-3 minutes. He just not playing, nothing. I'm just like, where did he go? I wonder where this guy went. And then all of a sudden he popped up down by my legs. And I'm like, oh, hey, buddy, good to see ya. But we had his leash on, right? We had his leash on inside because it's just a little easier to control the puppy that way. You know, if he starts getting out of hand, you have the leash that you can just pull back a little bit on and control the man. So he brings his whole body with his leash attached to him, and I go to pick him up. But as I pick him up, I smell something. And I'm like, that's shit. Like, that's poop. There's some poop somewhere. And I'm like, where's the poop? And I'm like looking at him. I'm like, do you have a dingleberry or something? Like, I'm looking at him. No poop showing there, so he's fine. Put him back down on the ground, and then he kind of backs up a little bit from me, but still is looking up at me like I did something I shouldn't have done, bud. So I'm like, where's the freaking poop? And I turn the collar, sorry, I turn the leash over, and there's the poop. A big, long, huge stain right across the backside of the leash, and it goes from almost right where his his leash hung down to the ground all the way to the handle. And at that point, I'm like, oh no. So, where did he drag the poop was the question. And I followed the trail all the way back to a nice shit right on the floor, which had a huge streak right through the middle and then all down the center of our living room and then out into the kitchen and then back into the living room and then on the floor by the TV. As I spent a good 30, 45 minutes cleaning up this shit. Oh, it was God. Everywhere I looked, there was more poop. There was poop everywhere. There was so much poop. It was a lot. So yeah, that's what ended up happening. We got ourselves a $5 donation over here from Dante151. Thank you, Dante. Seriously, Dante, thank you so much for your support tonight. Learn to walk him out after he eats. We are, man. He needs to learn as well, but sometimes accidents happen. He's 11 weeks old. People think that I've got like a 7-month-old pup. He's 11 weeks old. He's not even 3 months. AEW Rampage. One of those matches is Jay White versus Trent. Sweet, Dante. Sweet. Jay White versus Trent. Let's go. Have I got used to the smell of dog food? Yeah, I mean, it's not that strong of a smell for me. I did have a dog at my parents' house, so it's not like it's brand new to me, but I was only there for about a week of him being a puppy before I had to go back to school, so I didn't really get his puppy stages. Gradito says, Con man, I would love to stream more, but I work full time, 2 p.m. to 11 p.m., and then I go home and I stream till 5 a.m. some nights. Yeah, man. Hey, keep up the grind. Like, let me tell you something, Gradito. I have done that as well. Like, I have done the full day at work, come home, barely get a bite to eat, and go live or create a video. I did that for a solid 5 years, the first 5 years of this channel. That's what I did. It wasn't until the fourth. Or it wasn't until like my sixth year on YouTube that I truly started making enough money to turn it into a job. But I've been on YouTube for damn near 10 years, guys. Like, wait a second. That's not a legal tag. That's not a legal tag. Oh, Jungle Boy tried to tag in Luchasaurus, but he was taken out. Nice move again. The true question for Connor tomorrow is how much money does he lose betting on UFC? I hope no more than $50 because I'm just going to put $50 down and then I'm going to do the price of the pay-per-view as well. So $50 is going to be put on the line. Hopefully we win some stuff throughout the night. That way we can bet some more. But you know what we'll do? We'll obviously bet the $50 on the main event or whatever we kind of got left if we have enough left. Uh-oh, nice German suplex there from Jungle Boy. But there's the other Gun Club member. He went for another clothesline, did Jungle Boy, but he can't land it. Oh, Colton Gunn just got kicked in the face. Cordell Wender says, my dog got potty trained quickly. I don't know if you still let your dog all around the house, but you're supposed to keep him in a small area. As he grows and gets better at being trained, you introduce him to new areas. Yep, we got a child's gate up right now. He's only allowed to stay downstairs in the living room and the kitchen. So only two of like the four or five rooms that we have in this house. Man, Luchasaurus. Taking out the Ass Boys. Wait a second. The Ass Boys moved out of the way. Oh, there's a clothesline. And yeah, like, don't get me wrong, guys. Tucker's not all bad. Like, that's the worst part because, like, he has some moments where he's just so incredibly good, so incredibly well-behaved. Like, he's already got sit, lay down, and wait pretty much down pat if there's a treat there. If there's not a treat there, he's still working on it. but he's going outside for most of his potty breaks. He's not had one accident inside his play crate or his crate. So he's been doing really well that way. It's just sometimes he's not the best at it. We do have a couple puppy pads down as well so that he can go pee inside if he needs to. But the poops aren't that often inside, which is nice. He just happened to have a really bad one yesterday. Man, huge chokeslam though there from the Luchasaurus. Do you guys like Luchasaurus? Thumbs up, thumbs down, fist emoji right here in the chat if you do. And by the way, my friends, we've got ourselves a new boss. His name is Dante. 0151. Thank you, Dante. So becoming a one-time boss battle champion. Slides underneath. Luchasaurus gets taken down. Oh, Jungle. Oh, shoot. Jungle Boy just attacked Luchasaurus by mistake. A suicide dive where Austin Gunn moved out of the way. Nice neck breaker. Wait, deep into the cover. Oh my god, Jungle Boy 2! Oh, ho, ho, Christian makes the save. Wait, Billy Gunn now going after Christian. Oh no, Billy just took out Captain Charisma. The title in the hand! Colton Gunn just used the title! No way! Oh my god! The Ass Boys are gonna win! 2! Oh, kick out by Jungle Boy. Oh my god, I thought we just had new tag team champions. Wow. Whew. Brutal. And also, I know that a lot of the training just comes from the owner being consistent. We've done all the readings, watched a lot of YouTube videos. He's just having a bit of trouble getting the biting down pat. Other than that, I would say he's a really good dog. It's just the biting right now is really rough. Oh, a choke slam into the crowd. Colton Gunn just got taken out. Oh, Christian, I think, just hit a spear on Billy Gunn. Yeah. Austin Gunn went for the Famouser. Jungle Boy! Oh, there's the kill switch. 1, 2, it's over. Jungle Boy wins by himself. Using the kill switch. There you go. Because he is teething. Yes, exactly. Yeah, because he's teething. Yep. We've got a step-by-step, week-by-week book that we bought that literally tells us what to watch out for, what type of puppy he is around what week. And how to work with that puppy. But again, it's still just training. You know, it doesn't make it any easier. It doesn't make it happen any quicker. Still just training. Well, there it is, guys. That's Rampage tonight. I think this was a boring night of wrestling, if I'm being honest. That was... Yeah, like I think I enjoyed AEW a little bit more than SmackDown tonight. I must admit the match that I enjoyed the most, though, was Naomi versus Charlotte. That was the best match of the night, in my opinion. What do you guys think? What was the best match tonight out of both shows, out of Rampage and SmackDown? Whoa, 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 whoa. Jungle Light. All right, so here we go, guys. It is now time for the Reddit. Oh, yeah. Oh, man. Wrestling Reddit with Conman167. Let's do it, everybody. Wrestling Reddit with Conman167. We've got a new thing on the screen right now. New title, I should say. And let's switch this back over to SmackDown. Boom. Wrestling Reddit. And why is that going into the NXT reactions? That's not where I want it to go. It's not meant to go in the NXT watch-alongs. It's meant to go in the SmackDown watch-alongs. There we go. Boom. Boom. There we have it. All right. Reddit time. So, my friends, this is about to get a little cringy. This is Reddit. Welcome to the Conman 167 Reddit. If you guys have not done so, make sure you join our Reddit. It is available in the chat and in the description. So if you'd like to check that out, there you go. All right. So now I gotta change this up. Boom. Wrestling Reddit with Con. What will we see? What will happen? What will be cringy? What will be funny? What will be gross? What will be copyrighted? I wonder. It's the Conman 167 Reddit. Let's go to new. All right, my friend. Okay, I'm going to stop talking in that voice. Let's go all the way down here. Let's see what we got. So, Oh, yeah. This is what I'm going to do right now. I'm actually going to post a poll because we used to do these polls over on the community page, and I want to start doing them right here on Reddit. So, guys, the question is, what did you think of SmackDown tonight? What did you think of SmackDown tonight? So, the options are as follows. Freaking fantastic. Good. Just okay. Bad. Absolute trash. Or didn't watch. There we go. So my friends, make sure you go vote right there for what did you think of SmackDown tonight. And then we're also going to do one for what did you think of Rampage. All right, what did you think of Rampage? 5-6 options. So freaking fantastic, good, just okay, bad, absolute trash, didn't watch. All right, so there you guys go. Go over to the Reddit, and you've got two polls right there, so we will check in on that for what you guys rated the show at the end of it. But here we go. So, first up, what are we going to watch here? There's Conman with a beard. Official Mule Studios. So this is Raw. So I did ask you guys back on Monday Night Raw. What did you think of Raw? And some of you said freaking fantastic. Some of you said just okay. And then there was some votes right there. Bad, absolute trash, didn't watch. WWE needs to fuck off with Liv taking pins, says Turquoise Hawk. I agree with you. I agree right there. That's FamilyCon, so that's back from Monday. So here we go, guys. The official Mule Studios intro for now. All right. Boom!
Mule Studios.
All right. Equalize your audio. That's my one recommendation on that. Equalize your audio. There's Beardman 167. That's in my old house, man. Like, that is old. That's back when, like, Bob and I were still doing pay-per-views together. Wow. All right. So what do we have this here? We have Macho Studios official intro as well. Oh, boy. I'm a little scared. We're probably going to see it actually in his video, so we'll watch it there. So here we go. This is Smiling Con, a Smiling Friends parody. Wow, why can't I read? A Smiling Friends parody featuring an ad, a song, and a running gag that will get really old really quick. I'm really looking forward to it. Here we go!
I can hate losing the topic
cards.
Bowl in the punch bowl.
Hooray!
But I want to
bowl. Be whoopsie.
This is a bunch of barnacles!
Ha 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 ha! Oh boy.
This is gonna be great.
Con man.
I love helping kids. I love kids.
Con man.
I love kids.
I would really love one of these. Scream you out at the top of your lungs.
Oh hello. Are you the smiley?
Cons.
That's us, ma'am. Here to bring smiles and make the world a better place. Is your son home?
Oh yes, yes he is. Come on in. Come right in. I'm so glad you boys came. He's just right in here. I hope he's not sleeping. Desmond! The smiley
cons
are here.
Hey, little.
One sec. I'm gonna add a bigger disclaimer right there. He just said that this is a suicide joke, I guess. I don't know what's about to be played here, so please, everybody, just legitimately keep that in mind. If this is triggering towards you or something like that, I don't know what's about to play. So I hope it's respectful. I hope it's not anything crazy. This is the first time I'm seeing it too, okay, guys?
Let's take off, we're all ready to roll. It's fun to learn with the Jump Patrol. Wake up,
oh boy.
It's time to play. Come on, Captain
Veer.
Welcome the day.
We're Ali J.
Ready to go.
Module. Oh, there's no suicide joke in the rest of it? Okay, gotcha.
Goldberg.
Making something new.
Well, let's leave those out in the future, okay? There's no need for them. But thank you for not including it. I must have misread that little thing right there, and then the disclaimer. I just saw the the one part, and I was like, oh boy. His neck issues. Wait a second. Oh, hang on. I think the doctor is in.
Jay Lethal.
All right. 153 Meat Boulevard. This is the place.
Number 15. Could I get the number 15?
Sure thing, hon.
Oh my. That's
Ali J.
And now a word from our sponsor.
It's time to assemble the bombs.
I got you, Bobs.
Por favor, no me dejes, Roberta.
It's the call of the Bobs. It also works on Rob's.
Bob, vanilla ice latte.
Bobs.
Well, that's a happy little sound.
The Bobs are answering our call
to help everyone get the furniture they love in stock and fast.
Wow, this is some seashell.
Shop what's in stock, in store, or at mybobs.com.
And now for a song that I really, really, really want to be put in the Con Man musical. I call it Five Course Meal for a Vampire, Tiger. Yeah, five-course meal for a tiger. A.K.A. N.S. Cantor's worst nightmare. A.K.A. You get the point.
A little Chinese lesson for you. Man, man, chi means enjoy your meal.
Man, man, chi, it's no raw deal.
Is it roasted eel? Man Man Chi means bon appetit.
Man Man Chi, what do we have to eat?
444. Man, she, we've got room for more. I think I'm nearly done for. Man, she, don't get the squirts.
Man, she,
we'd rather eat our shirts.
Wait, stop!
Man, she. They love to eat on the Yangtze.
I think this is racist.
Big Tigers.
Fuck. Maybe I'm just being a little sensitive or whatever, but I don't know about that one.
Hooray! Lizard shit! Fuck! Shit, that shit, dirty old twat. 69 assholes tied in a knot. Hooray! Lizard shit! Fuck!
All right. Let's do the mule. Or no, not the mule. Let's do Macho Studios up next. All right. Anyways, let's do the next one. Oh, not gonna be. Thank you for not copywriting me.
Are you sure about that?
Are you gonna make me watch me? Okay, all right.
Take Maple Drive, otherwise we won't make the movie.
So you're gonna make me watch me react
just take
to something we've already seen?
No, we're not Big Tiger.
Compare our direct rates side by side to find you a great deal. Even if it's not with us.
There's a progressive ad.
Oh, that's helpful.
Well, why the frig was there a
progressive That's super duper quiet.
Actually, we invented that. It's like a sound.
Like.
Does it matter? You do that for me? Really? Yeah, I'd like that.
For ads? I got you, asshole.
Correct, I have a life mate.
Is that consequential?
With whom are you communicating?
Jake from Planet State Farm.
Jake from Planet State Farm at 03.
I'm not watching commercials. They're copyright, man. I can't show full commercials.
Bell, our company. It's like a sound.
You're gonna make me watch something we've already seen. Like, we just seen these.
Studios.
What the fuck? What is this?
I would like to proudly announce that Macha Studios has acquired Mule Studios. This purchase will take effect on June 5, 2022. This will be following their closure on May 30, 2022. New update. Jeopardy Part 3 is coming May 12th. I know he said April 17th on Twitter, but it's just gonna take longer than expected. Jeopardy! Part 4 is set to premiere on November 21st.
What the fuck? What the fuck? What the fuck? What? You've already got the year plan? You've already looked ahead all the way to November and be like, oh, I'm gonna make a meme video right there for November 21st. Like, what the fuck? Dude, it's fucking February. It's February. It's February. Oh my god. All right. We got who remembers Jinder Mahal as WWE champion in 2017? Let's get some J's in the chat for Jinder. All right. J's in the chat for Jinder. J's in the chat. J's in the chat. He doesn't have J's on his feet. He's got J's in the chat. No way. Tony Khan has a huge pancake breakfast with all your favorites. AEW Dynamite Live Wednesday, February 9th, 8, 7 Central on TBS. Oh my God. No way. Pick your poison. All right. Veer Mahan as Universal Champion or Veer Mahan and Goldberg as Tag Team Champions. Oh my God. You know what? Give that to me. I don't care. Give that to me. Sure. Sure. Let's see Veer and Goldberg be tag team champions. That actually looks good on him, though. Oh, Stone Cold Steve Austin coming on down at the Olympic Games. What's this here? Instead of peppermint tea, I should start drinking this in my streams.
Just do what I do when I'm looking for a job. Kick back, watch some TV, and chug down a carton of drinkable sausage.
Ew. 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 Fucking Jay Lethal! Alright, and then I think... Yes, I think this is our next video here. 5 minutes and 44 seconds. Thank you, Samuel Vlogs. 5 minutes and 44 seconds, less than the 6 minute mark. We love to see it. All right, here we go. And I won't be tonight. Did you guys all make new intros?
To introduce to you the president
of
Reddit con memes and
Mule Studios.
Thank you very much.
Today I'll be talking about the future of Mule Studios, and we have three main topics. But first, we're going to look at previews of what's coming up for the Mule Studios, including some new announcements for maybe March.
Coming soon to
Reddit.
Oh my God. I've got a little tip for you guys. Actually, you know what? This is a really good tip for all the Reddit video makers out there and everything. There's a really, really cool tool that you can use for your clips, and it's called equalization, EQ. Basically, go through and listen to your video, and if one part of your video is a little bit lower than the rest, raise that audio volume up, and just for that one single clip. And try to equalize your video. Here's another really good tip, though. If you want to, just simply export your audio once it's all done, once you have it all mastered, and then put it into a free program called Audacity. Run the normalization on it. It's called Normalize. Run the compressor, and then run Normalize again. And your audio will sound a lot better, a lot more normalized all the way across, a lot more equalized, okay?
Commands golf ball.
I'm Macho Studios.
I'm
Big Tiger.
And I'm
Samuel Vlogs.
We travel with the Lucha House Party. And we embrace the Lucha. And we like fucking around in Toronto.
But wherever we go, we know that
on Man 167
will be there with us.
Traveling the world as a tree.
Big Tiger,
Samuel Vlogs, Macho Studios.
With
on Man 167.
And some new friends too. Everyone's different and really they're just like you.
Toronto.
Let's go.
Con man.
Let's go.
Con man.
Let's go.
In March on Reddit.
Oh my God. and a half men. Oh my god, that sounds so wrong. Wheel. Ah. Con.
Con.
This can only happen in North Carolina.
Con man.
Oh, that's not going to be controversial at all.
Loyalty. And respect.
These were the ingredients chosen to create the perfect...
Three heroes.
Con Man.
Call my nostalgia.
The Powerpuff Girls were born! Using their ultra superpowers, Blossom,
good fucking lord. Are we now referred to as the Powerpuff Girls?
JD. His fans.
You're going... Oh, God. Oh, no! You're gonna get me in trouble, man. You're gonna get me in trouble. Tucker is by his side. Oh my god. The cringe is real.
Also coming, Conass, a collaboration with me and Big Tiger.
Good fucking lord.
Now for the first major announcement. Here's the songs for Conman the Musical. Hangman. Bandana and Ollie J is
no way I can't strip him
or I'll be calling 4K
and I'm allergic to
the Maple Leafs. Nuggy. And now for the second announcement. I have some sad news to share. Effective May 31st, 2022, Mule Studios will be shutting down. This is because I am moving to my dream area of the beach, and I cannot wait. So now for the third and final announcement.
Oh my god. Now you caught my attention. Good lord, Ollie J.
Yeah. Due to popular demand, on April 4th, 2022,
oh, we gotta wait.
Mule Studios presents Blockbuster event of the con memes. Set Mania! Live from the Bojangles Coliseum in Charlotte, North Carolina. Tickets.
Monday.
Or people,
okay, cool.
Or you claim who you want to sent for and who's your girl will go on sale this Monday. On my Twitter.
Yeah! Woo! The end! It's the end! Woo-hoo-hoo! That's what I'm talking about! The end is here! The end is here! The end is here. Alright, seriously though, I know I make fun of you guys. Thank you so much for putting the time and effort into making those videos. As cringe as they are, I know a lot of people enjoy them. And Samuel, my dude, you know, if you happen to change your mind at some point and you decide that, hey, I'm going to come back to making meme videos because the beach isn't actually going to take up all of my time, then you're more than welcome to do so. But if you don't want to, that is completely up to you. And I want to say thank you so much for making the content you have for us. Let's take a quick look right here at the polls. So, can I see the... No, I cannot. Okay, I'm going to give it mine. I'm going to give it a bad. I don't think SmackDown was that good. Look at that. A lot of people agree with me right there. Well, not a lot. A decent amount. Four people right there say bad. And then I'm going to give my pick right here for Rampage. I think it was just okay. just okay. And a lot of people said good. And then a lot of people said just okay as well. But that is going to do it for the stream on this channel today. But my friends, we are going to be going live over on On Con Games. All right, we're going live on Con Games. We're going to head over and play some Lost Ark. It is the launch day. So make sure you guys go join that stream. It's going to take me a few minutes to switch things over to launch the game and all that. But once we are live and we'll be live over there. So thank you so much, my friends, for watching along here today. I really hope you enjoyed. Before you leave, drop that like on this video. Make sure you're subscribed as always. And that's going to do it. So take care, my friends. Have yourself a wonderful rest of your day. I've been Con, and that was Friday Night Smackdown and AEW Rampage.